Can I ask you a question? It's a bit of a deep one about the same Derrick Jaxn guy, because you said that you saw through him.
Yeah.
And would you say that you could see him being an abuser type?
Yeah. I mean, the videos, he was sitting with his wife in the video, and it just looked really uncomfortable.
Thank you. People were saying it was uncomfortable in the sense where, oh, how did he just come and drag his wife onto the stage, blah, 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 blah. But I'm saying, and I think you're saying the same thing, uncomfortable in a way, in the sense where she looked afraid. Yes, 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 yes. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and dogs, rodents and other small insects, welcome to the Eloquently Saying Nothing podcast. Thank you very much for joining us for episode 290.
No, we must reach. It must be 299 now.
No. It's not.
It should be 297. It can't be 297.
Yeah. It's 297. It's definitely not 299. It's 297.
The way you went, sounded like Ricky, what's his name?
Oh. I don't know.
Yeah. The box.
Yeah, this is 297 still.
Oh, 297. My God.
297. This is long.
What?
These 200s are long, bruv.
Yeah, you want to get to 300.
I thought it was 300 ages ago.
No, I thought this was 299. I did think
you
so.
You know what? I think ESN Radio was messing me up.
Gaza.
Because we're doing two.
We're doing so many episodes every week now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's episode 297 of the Eloquently Saying Nothing podcast. Doing it 10 years strong, soon to reach 300. I reckon we should do another clubhouse on 300. We've been asked to repeat the clubhouse ring, by the way.
Yeah, there were a few people. It was well received, or what? Just a few people. Like,
I don't know. I didn't get any extra
review.
Well, maybe a couple, but nothing that I'm thinking. But people said, I missed that one. Can you do it again?
Okay.
So the thing I guess you were saying, like, can you give us a bit more warning? So because I want to be part of it. Not because obviously I can listen to it, but I would like to be there as well. So,
so that
kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So maybe for episode 300, it's up to you guys.
Obviously. Wahala the visionary.
Mm-hmm. I don't care what we do.
You can hashtag ESN pod. If you search for ESN pod, then we will give you information of what we're doing and what's coming up. So you can look for that hashtag as well. Plug. as well as using it to big us up.
Mm. Plug.
At ESN podcast on all the social medias.
Plug.
Mm. Rate and review us on all the things. Also, because we're coming up to 300, if you've never rated or reviewed us on the Apple podcast things or any of your apps that you listen to us, do that as a favor. That's for our 300th birthday, because
we've gone over 300, man.
We've gone over 300.
Yes,
yeah, we've done 300 episodes plus. Yeah, but
a couple of them didn't get put up because
no. They're bonus episodes, so we didn't give them out their own separate number. Mm. Or they're like when we interview Ty, that's a separate episode that we didn't give a number. Stuff like that. So we've done over 300 episodes. That's not whatever.
It's not a thing.
Episodes that have been split in half.
Yeah.
It's been the same number.
For real.
Stuff like that. Somebody mentioned the other day that we should have a, what's it, when they pay you? Is it Patreon?
Patreon.
Because they like to buy us a coffee or something like that. Thank you very much for that.
Yeah, that touched me actually. I
can't see it ever happening. But
maybe you never know.
What's Mr. Wolf, what are you saying?
I'm cold.
He just looks complicated. He looks confused throughout this whole beginning area. And I was thinking, is he confused because he doesn't know what we're talking about or something else? But he looked perplexed throughout this whole.
If you want to switch on the heater, bro, go switch on the heater. I can leave you to last.
I will do.
Let me. What mic number are you, anyways? You and him always get.
I'm number four.
Just make sure you turn it off before you leave.
Yeah, go on.
Okay. Okay, so let me get to my thing. So would you guys ever think about doing this Patreon thing? Because I can't ever see it happening.
I don't know. I know 90s babies have started a Patreon thing. Obviously Joe Biden
and Joe Biden. We'll talk about that.
People have had Patreon before, because who else had it? I know that like what's them girls, them that girl that I can't really stand, too tough, Mandy, and what's it called? Horrible decisions.
Yeah,
they've had a Patreon for ages.
Enough people have Patreon.
I think what's the name had a Patreon? Flagrant 2. That's got a Patreon. That's the one with Andrew Schultz and the Asian guy.
Coming through as an old person. I know what a Patreon is, but I don't understand the mechanism.
It's just OnlyFans type thing, basically. But it's basically like OnlyFans.
So it's like another separate channel.
It's you put content on there and and you charge for the content.
Yeah.
All right. So it's a content commitment thing.
Yeah. All it could be video, it could be audio podcast, it could be.
And that's why some of them, whatever. They do all of them at the same time, innit? They will have like three different networks that they're on and they'll just have the camera for each different network all at the same time. So you get they'll record once and then it goes on all three of them.
Basically, what they'll do is it will be a case of maybe they'll do your normal episode. Mm. If we're going to have a podcasting thing, they'll maybe have a normal episode that they do weekly. And if you want exclusive content, you make an episode or something else for Patreon.
Yeah.
So or maybe you might be behind the scenes or whatever.
There's ones I know where they, like, if you're part of our Patreon, not only do you have an extra episode, you can reach out to us. So you can, instead of us saying what questions you want to answer them, blah, 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 it's like only Patreon people can reach out to us. We'll answer your questions, but on Patreon. So you pay for the privilege, all that stuff.
I know
there's other ones where they have events, and if you're a patron, you're the only ones that can come to the events.
Yeah, and you might get, or you get tickets first or something. I know Joe Budden's got a Discord group, so I know that Discord obviously you need to invite people to be able to get in.
Yeah, I know about Discord.
So then obviously if you pay for the Patreon, you get access to the Discord group where they talk to the people.
Okay. All right.
Which I don't know why you do that, but anyway,
And going to my very negative thing, I never thought anybody would be paying extra money for anything.
Listen,
like anyways,
people pay, but for an NFT, has shown me that people pay for anything.
I want to get my,
did you hear about the toilet tissue?
No, go on.
Somebody paid, like, made some drawing on the toilet tissue and they paid for it. NFT'd it and paid for it.
But we discussed that the NFT thing, it could be like a tax.
I think it's a tax evasion, but anyway.
It's a tax evasion.
I bet women will pay for you to give them relationship advice. And men.
We'll get to that as well.
Yeah. Oh, yes, we will.
He got a big name.
He ain't got a big name.
Kevin Samuels and this brother, Derrick Jaxn.
You better know him because my wife was. I don't know this guy.
I've never heard of him before.
Sorry for this man. I don't know this man. I don't know this man.
Yeah, I know who Derrick Jaxn is. I would have mentioned him on this podcast a few times.
Everyone that tells me. Even if you did mention him, here's the thing. I would have watched a few seconds of him and be like, no. And that would have been it. I would have paid no mind to that man again. The way he talks, the way it's like, no.
Everybody said to me, or everyone that I've heard speak about this man, they all say, oh, every man hates him. And I'm like, I don't even know if they hate him.
Yeah, for me, it wasn't a hate. It was just, I can see through you.
Yeah.
And I would have debates and arguments with other women to say that I'm hating on him. I'm like, I'm not hating on him, but if I can see through him and you cannot, there lies the problem.
It's very interesting. It's very interesting the men that women are happy to follow. Mm-hmm. It's very interesting. And it's usually men that tend to agree with their standpoint of view or what they believe to be.
And good looking.
Yeah, good looking. Mm-hmm. What they believe to be the truth about standpoints of view for men. And maybe they echo their sentiments that they believe. So maybe that makes sense. I don't know. But it's just interesting the people that they don't like the people that's extra raw, which I can understand because you don't need, sometimes I think that's unnecessarily raw.
But sometimes you sweat.
Those people are sometimes very right. It's one of those catch 22s, isn't it? It's one of the catch 22s.
Who's that one that used to be on ESN? He's got a restaurant up north. And,
ESN?
Rob. Yeah, because somebody said situation with is like they're up. I was like, what did they up do that is similar?
You remember he wrote a relationship book, innit?
Yeah, but then, so what?
But I don't remember him telling like he was something that he was not. Yeah. I remember him telling that he was like a dirty guy and he was telling people how to avoid dirty guys. That was the whole premise of.
So that's what I was thinking. My missus said, somebody said that. What did he do? That would liken him to this dude.
I don't know.
The dirtbag.
From what I know from him, he obviously wrote his book. His whole thing was about.
Are you talking about the ESN guy?
Yeah.
Okay. Dare Rob, man. Shout him out, man. Real hustler, right?
Yeah.
There.
Shout him out his restaurant as well. Shout out his restaurant when it opens.
Scion,
when it opens up in London again, when he can open it up.
I'll
go there and check it out.
I've already linked up to him, but I said to him, yeah, I'm going to come true.
Yeah, well, we can go together then. We can run down there. But yeah, his one was basically, he was just used to do like relationship advice, but he used to be funny because he used to have like his catchphrases and blah, blah, blah. But he was basically, his whole premise was, I was a dirty dog. I'm telling you how to avoid dirty dogs.
Mm.
But he was never ever telling anybody that he was clean.
Yeah, and that's
he would tell a woman he's cheated. He would tell you all the dirty things he's done.
All right, we'll get to Derrick Jaxn in a minute.
I'm not going to be a story about that guy, though, anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Let me start off. I am Stavros Boss. Hold on, let me ladder this up because I need to ladder it up before I start.
That's how you know you are African. Loud it up.
Yes. Is that the wrong term?
No, well, let me loud it up.
Loud it up.
And then Jamaica's so loud up the thing now.
I am Stavros Boss.
Yes, you are.
And you can catch me at Stavros Boss on all social medias. In front of me, I have my big brother, my younger brother, who's also my big brother, Big Wahala. The big part was there. I don't know.
Big Wahala on Twitter.
Man's whispering for us, you know.
Get your one-stop dreadlock shop, do rags and swimming caps at one-stop dreadlock on Insta.
Plug it.
Make sure you get it.
Plug it.
Just was told yesterday that it's the finest do rags that some people have. They're the only ones that are still in people's heads. Mm. I've been hearing that. The streets is talking.
One stop.
There's holidays maybe coming up. So, yeah, you know.
Man. When you're ready to swim in it.
The swimming ones are going to help.
Who's those that, my man?
Yeah, man.
Yes.
Yeah. So go and buy your do rags.
To my left.
Caps.
Yes.
Anting.
What's the socials that they should look for that thing?
At one stop dreadlock on Insta. You can find them there still. One stop hair care as well, also.
To my left, I have.
Yes.
Mr. Wolf.
What is going on? What's happening, people? This week's Yoruba proverb goes like this. I'll go straight into it. Aki igbo kuku ojo da omigba nu. Yes. Aki igbo kuku ojo da omi. Agbanu. Agbadanu. Yes.
When you say yes after that.
You did it twice the first time.
Yes.
They say it again.
Yes.
And that translates to never pour. It's, you know, I'll go word here. And I want to know how it gets
pronounced. Spell it first.
let me say it first. Never pour water away in the trough. Is it, or is it troth?
Trough.
Troth. I think Africans say cho. We say tro.
No, we, bro. Speak for yourself.
T-R-O-U-G-H.
Troth.
I know it's troth, yeah. But we say tro. Tro.
I don't know about that.
I don't know.
Just like it's towel, we say towel.
Towel.
We say towel. Go and bring me the towel. Yeah. Anyway, never pour water away.
It's probably is towel, you know.
Probably.
And people have messed up and said towel.
Never pour away the water in the trough simply because the cloud rumbles. Never pour away the water in the trough simply because cloud rumbles. And the wisdom translation is, don't be presumptuous, never count your chickens before they hatch. Of course, catch me on Insta, aka Mr. Wolf, on Twitter, aka _ Mr. Wolf. What's going on?
I give up with you people talking like this and then talking like this.
Every meet you moan about
that's,
something.
That's just how I talk, I guess, innit?
Just try and level yourself up, man. We're talking about 300 episodes. You man should be professional.
Go 1 week if
you're, because I shout, but when I shout, then you notice I move back. And then when I'm talking to my voices, I move forward.
Oh, sorry, God.
Yeah, because people die like this. It's like,
bro, sorry, God of podcasting. Don't strike us down, Lee, with your power of podcast.
Listen, I'm getting even worse in my old age. There's a podcast now. If give me a couple of episodes with poor quality, and I'll just unsubscribe now.
That comic book podcast you sent me. That guy really gets on my nerves.
Oh my God.
That one.
Why?
He's overly excited and he's breathing into the mic like he's masturbating to the comic book.
I haven't noticed.
But those are comic book people.
Nah, man. Oh, Nightcrawler. Oh, he's so great. I'm like, what's wrong with this guy?
I'm 3 hours into Justice League.
I know Batman doesn't like you know. That can't complete it.
I finished it.
It won't go where.
I finished it in one.
That's like, because I'm trying to get through.
And he's 3 hours into Justice League.
I'm trying to get through. What's this? So old.
Bring me the. What do you call it?
Snowfall.
Snowfall. Do you mix up your children's name?
No.
Okay, you're not there.
Yeah. You're not boy and a girl. No, if he's got two.
When did that matter?
But my mum does.
If my grandma is ready to mix up names, it doesn't matter whether you're a boy or a girl.
So with your own mum and dad.
Don't matter.
My mum does it all the time. But that's like 4 episodes of Snowfall, bruv.
So?
It's like, you know.
I watched the other day.
4 or 5 episodes of Snowfall.
I watched the other day.
Oh, 4 hours, you know.
15 episodes of Sopranos.
Yeah, but we know that there's something wrong with you already.
15 hours in one day.
Simple just said it, man.
Oh, we know that there's something wrong with you already. So that's
in one day.
Fuck. So what did you do for the other?
He was bathing in his own dirt that day. I woke up, I bathed, I watched Sopranos.
You didn't bath, did you?
I bathed. Have you got TV in the bathroom?
No.
I know you don't, because you know one of our cousins is getting the TV put up in the bathroom, innit?
No. Oh, is he?
Yeah. Or they.
See,
they're doing it now. I was in there and it's like, hey, TV, that would be dangerous for me, man, because I've spent enough time in there anyways.
What are you talking about?
But if you had, the ones that you should live put too TV far from you. Inside your
Which one?
Inside your toilet,
bro. The couple.
Oh yeah. They got that. Yeah.
Listen, like 15 hours of one show just in one go. Some people take crack.
But I can do that. I didn't have anything else to do.
How many episodes?
I couldn't walk. So that's what I couldn't walk out anyway. So I just sat down and watched Sopranos.
If you could walk, you would have done it, bro.
No, if I could walk, I probably would have found myself out. But because I couldn't, and I wanted to make sure that I didn't go out, because you know me already, I'm supposed to be doing something. I'm supposed to rest my leg at that time, and I was not resting it. So this, I actually took the day, I worked to work from home that day because I couldn't walk. So
you worked from home and you watched 15 episodes of a TV program. To my right, we have our favorite.
Let's just say I didn't get any calls that day.
Our favorite Lux Rastafari man, Simple Simon.
Murder, She Wrote.
Agatha Christie.
What? Murder, She Wrote, and She Will Not Take That Back. Shuffle the deck, and she's bound to be the queen in the pack. Gaza. Extremely short excerpt from a poem by the Right Honourable Patra. In its original rendition, the poem is called Queen of the Pack, and it goes a little something like this. Bama drop! Damn you! I'm telling you now, Patra season is coming.
Watch me. Bring back the pompo shorts, man. Murder me wrote, I may
not take back my chat. Gaza.
Shuffle the deck, me and the queen in a the park. Look how me cute and sexy like that. And me plan the council, no better watch that. Show me step up in a life, them want to give me a fight.
Yes.
Show me look cute and them don't look too right.
Yes.
They call and need to over me, man, a fight.
Yes.
And that now one, no time in a them life. Me no cut up, I can model every time. Absolute niceness, come with beer rhyme. First class dress code and your style, I lick.
I love bottom too much. I'm natural.
What did you say again?
It's unnatural. What is the first thing you said? I love bottom too much.
And we get into Lil Nas X.
Jada Kingdom.
At Simple Simon FB on Twitter. I don't have Instagram. Gaza, we say Forever Alliance on the Foundation. We say bang, and we say bang, bang.
And we say bring back pedal pushers.
Before I forget,
Jada Kingdom's the woman I was talking about.
Oh, okay. Jada. Oh, yes.
Let me look at this woman after this. Yes. This is one of my favorite drill songs. And I was singing it as I came in. And a conversation sparked off.
Magnum Silver.
Just gonna let the chorus play. Let the chorus play first. Listen to the lyrics, it's important.
Who's that, my man? Jump up, fry man. Why is he leaving his right hand? Come back, little boy. Jump up, rise this toy. Jump up, rise this toy. Jump up. Who's that, my man? Jump up, fry man. Why is he leaving his right hand? Come back, your boy. Jump up, rise this toy. Jump up, rise this toy. Jump up.
Did you do the intro? Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. We're all done on that side now. So,
I wanted to put
I just love
no
the
buses and only buses at cycle lanes under the road as a sporting six.
Oh, and them stupid fragmented roundabout kind of things as well.
Yeah. Right there.
Yeah. Cool. So I love that chorus. It's like, hey, who's that, my man? So I see him. Yeah, flames him, and then somebody's running. So there's two of them. And he said, hey, don't leave your boy. Come back and back your boy. Don't leave him.
Wait.
And so while I had a question about leaving your boy.
Yeah, so I was saying, if you actually was on, because, you know, you was getting to the point where you was chatting, right? And, you know, you see the ops, as they call them, the ops, yeah?
Don't leave him.
You know what the ops is, isn't it, Mr. Wolf?
Yes.
Okay, just wanted to confirm. Because of the age.
Do you want to maybe flesh it out? For
no, he said you know.
No, but there's people that may not.
Well, they should know. So the ops there.
Don't
see,
leave them.
You see opposition and the opposition, if I have to put it out.
He thought it meant other people's property.
Yes. But anyway.
No, that's OPP.
Ooh, you know them acronyms. So that you spot him and then you go, hey, blood, fingers, they're chasing him. So you see them with all their knives, guns, whatever, right? And you both start running, right?
Don't leave him.
And then he falls over. and they're going to catch him because he fell over.
Angels with dirty faces.
Are you going to come back and collect him and both of you maybe die? Or are you leaving him because he fell over?
Don't leave him.
And in Mr. Wolf's case, he was overweight and you've constantly been telling him that he should lose weight.
Because we know you're a fattest. Or was it a waitist?
A waitist?
Or whatever it's called.
I'm not a waitist.
You discriminate against big people, man.
Oh, hell no, I don't. Bro, I just
you like me less them. Because I have breasts. It even rhymes. I like...
Come back and back your breasts.
I like you more that you've got breasts, to be fair.
No comment.
Pause.
I'm just...
A friend in need's a friend indeed.
You know.
Friend with weed is better.
So what are you doing?
I feel funny now.
I'm leaving him.
You're leaving him?
Probably. we're both going to die. What am I dying for?
Okay, so all of us could get it, basically.
I don't know what I'll do. To be honest, in fact, you know me. I probably wouldn't leave somebody. So,
okay. It's a tough one. I don't know, to be honest with you, but I know that...
My head says leave. My heart says stay.
But I my thing is, how do I explain to your parent that I left, man? And that's the difficulty for me.
That I'm going to die.
Or nobody explains anything.
Exactly. What am I explaining to your parents for? Like, I was there.
What happened?
Okay, we were there. Somebody chased us. They fell, and then they got murked. We had no weapons on us. They did. If I ran back, I would be dead too. I'm sorry, Mama. I'm sorry, Miss Jaxn.
I'm sorry, Miss Jaxn.
I want to live.
I don't know if I can live with that.
You wouldn't be living in it. If you said that there's a chance that the two of you could take on whoever it is,
because
that you had something, or it's just it was an equal distribution of force, then that's different.
Yeah, but
that's
you're different. Saying death comes to both of
you. You didn't even say you're going to get a battery. Like, you're going to get battered.
I'm saying there's an opportunity. I'm just saying they had the weapons, they had the opportunity, and it's likely that they're going to do something. They're going to do, at least if it's not death, it's going to be extreme damage.
All I'm saying is,
I've got a kid, man.
I've seen it. I've seen the reality of that. We've all seen it, actually. We just don't realise it. Stephen Lawrence situation is exactly that. They were both ran. Stephen got caught up.
Yeah, and the other guy.
And the other guy got up. And I've seen that other guy. And I don't know if I could be him. Because even the way he talks and stuff, like, he's had to go through a life of therapy. Because as far as he's concerned, I left my brethren. And every interview I've ever seen, that's all he's ever said. I left my brethren.
Fair dues. Do you have a issue with him?
I don't have an issue with him.
All right. So from the outside, can we all say that if we look at that actual example, somebody was chasing you. You didn't know that they had a weapon. You didn't even know they had a weapon, I don't think.
Yeah.
So, but you just knew you were outnumbered and they're chasing you. You ran, your boy got left behind, and you carried on running. Now, do any of us have an issue with this friend of Stephen Lawrence?
I don't have an issue with the friend of Stephen Lawrence.
I don't.
I don't either. But
no,
there's certain men that will tell you, you know what? It's a weird situation.
Don't leave him.
No, because it's a weird situation. Because if this was a road thing, right? If this was a road thing,
yeah,
then you exactly what Digga D said is Digga D.
Oh, you come back and back your boy.
You have to come back and back your boy. Don't because it's a road thing.
Wait.
You can't go back to your boys and say you left my man on his own. After, if there's something where there's a beef between two crews or there's a beef between certain men because of certain situations.
You say that. But you're not a roadman.
Yeah, I'm not a roadman, but I'm saying that's what I'm saying. It depends on what type of person you are.
I don't know what these roadmans is thinking, innit?
Because the same thing with the snitching thing where they have this code about, you know, you're a civilian, you can do what you want. You can call police because you're not involved in the road. But if you're a roadman, you can't do that. I think it's kind of the same with this type of situation. I think if you man are on this thing normally, you know, you're always ready to back your boy, you're fighting all the time, blah, blah, blah. And this just so happens to be an outcome of the beef that you had in the past. Because imagine if you're the one that's actually got beef with the people. And they were chasing you, and you're actually the friend is the one that actually gets murked for your own situation. Can you imagine? Because you didn't go back to back it, even if you're the reason why that situation occurred in the first place.
That's what I'm saying to you. It's a bit much.
So it is a lot.
So what are you doing?
I don't know.
Mr. South London.
I don't
know. Captain South.
There could be repercussions, you know. It, like you said, if you are from the road and the man that you're leaving, your vision that you're leaving survives, you get me? There could be different kind of repercussions. Not to say that you want that person to dead, but you could be damned if you do and you're damned if you don't. That's the kind of situation that you find yourself in. But no, no. Me personally, who is not a road man or affiliated to any gangs, same as Steph. That is just the bottom line.
What if you were the slow one then? and you saw your boy leaving you.
What?
Don't leave him.
I mean, wait. I think that you kind of have the understanding that, at least I would anyway, that, I don't know, that listen.
I shouldn't have eaten all these burgers.
No, it's just like...
Each man for himself.
Each man for himself. That's the terminology that I was looking for. I couldn't find it. But, you know, when you're in that kind of situation and you're a road man, it is kind of that. Listen, you get away, we split up, and we try to, you know, link up later.
I will say one thing. If I didn't have parents and I didn't have children or a child, and maybe if I didn't have a wife as well, then because when you get married or when you hook up with somebody for life, one of you is going to die first, innit? So it's kind of like, that's what's going to happen, innit? But when you have a child who's a young child, you don't want to leave that young child's life before you've fleshed out their life, innit? Okay, so that's one thing. And then when you're a child to parents, you don't want to go before your parents. So all of that would play in my mind. I don't want to die before my parents. Yeah, so I don't want them to lose another child as well. So no, that's one thing. So you as my bedroom is a different story, isn't it? Because that makes a difference.
Yeah, but what else is going to die regardless? Yeah,
but my bedrooms, it's like, when I look at it, it's like, can I put my parents through that? For you. And yeah, I love you as my boys, but I don't love you more than my parents. End of story. Yeah, simple things. So that's one. Then two, I have a responsibility to my child. That's the first and foremost what I put my, that is what I'm on earth for now that she's here. And you boys, again, it's not as important as my daughter. So can I risk losing my life and having her being raised by potentially some Ghanaian if my wife goes back home and finds some Ghanaian? I can't have that. So again, I don't love you for that. My wife, the reason I say my wife potentially is because when you hook up with somebody, somebody's going to die first. So I reckon usually women outlast men. So I'm probably going to die before, like statistically, I'm going to die before my wife. I'm less fit. I'm older. And then women live longer anyway. So I'm probably going to die before my wife. So it's just, if it was 80 or 90 or 40 or 50, it's what it is.
I think about this. Sorry,
he's made very, very good points. But from the outside, he looks like if we were to, as a metaphor for what he just said, is basically, bruv, hold me back, bruv. Hold me back. I don't want
to
do this.
He's never asked to be held back. Let me go.
Yeah, he's basically, well, from what I understand is that if I have nothing to lose, then I will back my boy.
If I was a single man with no family, then it's a different story.
See, this is the thing about with this. This is the situation I have in my head. And I think about this more than I probably should in life. Because I'm the only one, apart from Webslinger, I'm the only one really with no kid. I always feel myself to be, my life to mean less than you guys.
You feel more dispendable?
No, I just feel like my life is less worth less.
Expendables.
In a way.
I wonder if the multitude of people who haven't got kids feel the same way.
Probably not. But I the way I view kids is a lot different than a lot of people.
I was going to say, but so it can't be, it's not, yeah, because your idea has a lot of implied stuff with it, because the actual point of having children isn't what's making your value less. Because there's loads of people that have children and they're just not in their lives.
Well, I don't agree with that though.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying to you. So the implied stuff is what you don't agree with. That you're talking about having children and them being, and you being an active
part. If I thought that you're not an active part of your child's life, then that's different, I suppose. But if you're, yeah. If you are an active part of your child's life, like all of you lot are, and I said, I'm not talking about necessarily strangers. I'm talking about my immediates, isn't it?
I see her sometimes, my daughter. I see her sometimes.
I'm talking about my immediates. So I view my life less than you guys in a way, and I've always felt that way. And I have these same scenarios going in my head. Like if there was ever a case where I had to, like there was one of us had to die for something and the rest of it has to live, I'd always be the first one to just put my hand up because I got no kids.
I had a mad dream the other day that for some strange reason, somebody was coming to be with me and I had my daughter with me, and I was in the dream. There was like, the dream was about what should I do in that situation? Whether I should give it up or whether I should not have it.
Whatever it is, you give it up. Why are you wasting time fighting for it?
I don't know, but that's what the dream was.
Nah, man.
The dream was I was stuck between the decision of whether I give it up or whether I fight.
If somebody's prepared to do anything in front of your six-year-old child, she's 6'9" or 5.
She's 6'9".
Yeah, 6-year-old child. Then that person's mad. Just give it up. Why would you even have the argument?
Yeah,
I think it's easier said than done, you know.
Yeah,
I think that when you find yourself in a situation, I think the notion, I saw a video just today of an Uber cab driver in DC who was getting carjacked, and he didn't want to give up the car, and he eventually died.
Did he have his 6-year-old child in the car?
No.
This is what I'm saying. There's a difference between you being on your own and you being with your 6-year-old child.
I know. But the point that I'm making is that sometimes when you're put in a situation where the right thing to do is to just back off and leave it, when you're faced with that situation, sometimes your reactions get the better of you. So if somebody done something that was, you know, out of the ordinary or really bad, and my daughter or my son was around, I know what the right thing is to do. What I teach my son is, you know, God forbid this happens, but if he ever gets approached or somebody tried to rob him, make sure that you just give up what they want. Don't get into any kind of confrontation. You know what I mean? And there was the murder in, I think it was Lee Bridge Road, where they were selling stuff.
Yeah,
and
the clothes, whatever.
You get me? It's you know, when someone automatically is trying to take something from you, your natural reaction isn't just to give it up.
Yeah, we know this.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know this. Some people's is.
Okay, well, I think the natural reaction for many people is not just to give it up, innit? It's just like,
maybe not, you know? Maybe Stan might be right. It might be more people natural to give up, and there's certain type of people that will refuse to give it up.
I think maybe your natural reaction is not to give it up. Most people, when somebody has, when they're under threat, whatever they perceive as threat, and somebody's asking them for something or was demanding it.
I'm not going to say everybody, but I'm going to say that there would be a big number of people.
I think most is the other way, though.
I don't know. We don't know. We're just speculating, innit?
Yeah.
You get me? Like, you know, so there's going to be a lot of people that are going to be like, you know, put their defense mechanism up straight away and say, no, you can't have this. This is mine.
It all depends on how it's done as well.
Yeah, but the point I'm making is that when you find yourself in that situation, it's hard to... I think some people may find it difficult to do what we deem to be as the right decision.
In those situations where there's no one else involved, I get it. But with your child, I don't think that would be a situation.
Yeah, but this is what I'm saying is that the right thing to do would be to allow it.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm saying? But sometimes the reaction, and even depending on what it is, you know what I mean? Maybe you're thinking, I can't just allow it. I need to do something. Or your reaction is to lash out.
I don't know. I think I'm more of a person that if I was to give it up then, maybe if I wanted to do something, I would do it later. But at the time when I'm at a disadvantage. If I find you later, then me and you have a problem. But at the moment, I'm at a disadvantage. And you know, maybe it's got to a point where I feel differently because most of the stuff I've got, I can get again.
Yeah, but
I never used to thought I could get these again. I can't afford to get these again, or I can't afford to get that watch again, or I can't afford to get that thing again.
In the situation that I'm talking about, or the what my dream was about, which is weird for me because I don't dream normally, but in that situation, it's not really so much about the value of the things. It's about your child, which is a different type of value. And also, I don't know, there was a very animalistic presence about it where... In nature, if that vulnerable situation happens where the parent and the child is together, the parent is prepared to die to protect the child.
Yeah, but you're not protecting the child by then wanting to get involved in a scuffle.
But you're not getting involved in a scuffle. Something's coming to you.
Yeah, but you're saying the person was coming for you, for something. Yes?
Yeah.
So then
the quickest way to neutralize it is to give them what they want.
That's going to be the most likely situation where they won't escalate to where your child is actually in danger.
I hear
you're pushing your child into danger.
More danger.
That's why I said it's an animalistic thing, because when a lion is faced with that same situation, you don't see them cowering away. They are going to fight whatever comes towards them. I had that kind of feeling.
But that's different though, because usually they're coming for your food, which means that it's then going to be detriment to your cubs.
I see animals when they see something sometimes bigger and stronger come. Cub. Animals leave. They don't, it's like they understand they're beaten. I think animals are actually, when people talk about animalistic this and animalistic that, most animals know
they want to run.
I'm outnumbered or this one's bigger than mine, and they go the opposite direction.
Sometimes they're coming for the cub, man. And you see it on YouTube.
That's different. If you're defending your chicklings, it's a different story.
If Simple said this man came to come and collect my daughter, I wouldn't say, yeah, just give up.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? He said that he's coming to collect something from you. I don't know what even the something is.
So let's use that as an example. Do you just retreat or do you fight back?
If somebody's coming to take my child.
Yes.
Do but you, that's a stupid question you, now for me no, as well. No, like no. I said,
do you take your child and retreat, as in try to run, or do you protect your child and fight back?
Both it's of them are protecting question. Your child. Both of them are protecting your child, by the way. Okay. Running is not protected.
Okay. But you know what I mean.
Yeah, but it's, some people might say that's a Freudian thing that you're saying there, that if you
do you retreat or do you stand your ground?
If you stand and fight, that is protecting your child, and taking your child and running away, you didn't say that was protected.
Okay, but well,
as far as I'm concerned, that's protected, isn't it?
Okay. That's even still the smarter play. If I can get away, I'll get away, because if I die in that situation, then he's got my child.
Mm-hmm. I can't
do anything again now.
I think that's the correct thing to do, but I'm just saying, it's to retreat. But when you find yourself in those situations, it's very hard for me, just looking at that and putting myself in that situation. It could be my wife or my girlfriend, and someone slapped her on the bottom, for example. You understand? Like, how do you deal with that?
Because I'll get beat up for that one.
But this is it. It's like, you know, if there's two guys or if there's one guy or whatever, you know, how do you deal with that? Do you retreat?
I was watching Black-ish. I know Stab likes Black-ish.
Yeah, man.
And there's an episode where the man is out with his wife,
yeah,
and his dad and his mom, right? And they're in the line to get their car and the valet thing, yeah? And one guy comes in and pushes the main character's wife, pushes her out of the way, basically, and so he can get his keys first. And she's like, "Oh, what are you doing?" And then the man, like the husband, was like, "Sir, what are you doing? Blah blah blah." And he was like, "What? What are you gonna do about it? What?" And then he was like, basically, the guy was like, he goes, "Are we really gonna do this?" Like, that's what the man said. And then the dad came and just basically said to him, basically, this chiefed up the man and said, "What? What are you gonna do about it? What? I'm 60 years old. I have nothing. I'm a blah blah blah. I'm ready to go for this. What? What are you gonna do?" And then basically, the man backs away, and then walks off. Now the grandma and granddad don't get on, yeah? They hate each other, basically.
No, they like each other.
Well, they love each other, but hate each other at the same time, yeah? But when this happened, the grandma then suddenly went to sleep with the granddad after they've not been together all this time, yeah? Because they're not together. So now she went to sleep with the granddad, and now the wife was looking at the husband like, "What kind of pussy is you, basically?"
What program was this?
And she's a pacifist as well.
Yeah, she's very passive. Her name's Rainbow. She's a proper, like, one of those hippie children, that type of stuff. And I don't think in her instinct she would have thought that, she would have felt like that, because he was driving home like it was nothing. Like, oh, he wasn't even talking about the situation. He was talking about something completely different. And she was like, "Are you not acknowledging what just happened then? Like, your dad had to come and back your boy."
Basically,
and you was acting like a pussy. And I was thinking to myself, but that's one thing. My wife says stuff to me like that sometimes, where she thinks, there's times when I think my wife thinks I should get angry about certain things that I don't. And there's times when I get angry and she's like, "Why are you angry now?" And I always say, my anger comes with what I can do. Like, if somebody says something to my wife on the internet, yeah, right, I might get angry and tell them. I always like to tell my wife, don't get involved with people on the internet anyway, because this is the foolishness that can occur, yeah? So I'm always in that camp anyway. You are there talking to these people. Don't talk to them. Then this won't happen. But I'm also in the case of, you know, if you disrespect my wife, I would tell you something. But then I also think to myself, what am I going to do?
I'm not like that on the internet.
Yeah, what am I going to do arguing on the internet with this person? So if it's face to face, I'll give them a punch in the face. But now I'm just arguing with somebody on the internet over something that I don't think anyone should be arguing over. It's something that's got nothing to do with the two of you most of the time as well. Something about one stupid celebrity or something that's happened there, and you've all got different opinions, and now suddenly you're abusing each other on the internet.
Because you're behind computer.
Yeah, exactly. If you were face to face, it'd be a completely different thing.
Exactly, would never
so
do that.
So my wife would be like, maybe she'll feel like she'll be more aggressive in those types of situations, when I'm just like, forget about it. She's like, you know, she says sometimes, like, I'm not, she doesn't get into these arguments often at all. But if something happens, like, she starts trying to stay away from these groups as well. But if something happens, she tells me, and she feels a way about it, at times it's like, these people are stupid on the internet, don't pay attention to them. That's how I feel about it, because there's nothing I can really do. But there'll be other times when, I don't know, something could happen. It could be the slightest thing, and I might just be annoyed or angry about a certain situation, and I might show some form of aggression. And she's like, "Well, why did you show aggression in this situation?" And I explain that maybe I feel like this person was disrespecting us, or something that maybe she doesn't see. Because sometimes, you know, women see things that we don't see, and sometimes we see things that women don't see.
Yeah, Jaxn, whatever his first name is, Derrick Jaxn.
Yeah,
because men see something that women clearly didn't see with him.
In certain situations, so in that type of way, it's a thing. So I get that. That thing with the wife, and it's a bit different, and maybe you'll get beat up in a situation with your wife or whatever. But even then,
yeah, man,
the first thing I would say to her is, you have to be careful with that as well, because some people's wife shout out to Yoms because he doesn't understand this. Some people's wives are just as aggressive as you. So you're getting into this beef, suddenly she's getting into the beef, and then now you have to tell her to sit down.
I was watching a film last night, Safe House, and there's a bit where one of the characters calls his missus and tells her, go to your friend's house. No explanation, no nothing. Hey, pack a bag, go to your friend's house. And she waited, she paused for 5 seconds. And she's like, all right then, all right? Now, this man is meant to be a normal, everyday working man. So this is not, he's not a road man. He's not a government man as far as she knows. So there's no reason for her to have this phone call, this conversation with him. But he's like, hey, check out outside. Who's outside? It's like, oh, there's a police car there. He's like, pack a bag and go to your bedroom's house. Done. She said, yes. That was, and
white,
then,
white
and,
woman?
Yeah. And then he hung up the phone. And then this, I was watching this with my,
because no black woman is going without asking you 20 million questions.
I was watching this with my woman and what did I say? You wouldn't do that. And she's, before I had finished, she said, I knew you were going to say that. I knew it was coming.
You know what's so funny? Same thing happened. Same thing happened with my missus as well.
There is no way.
We watched the film. The same thing happened. And I said to her, exactly the same way he did. I just turned to her and I said, you know that would never happen with us, right? She was like, what do you mean by that? I said, if I phoned this house from somewhere outside and told you to leave now, grab our daughter, and leave
and go.
You're gonna ask me a million questions. You ain't ask. You're not just gonna go.
What?
Why would I ask you a million questions? I said,
I got my nails to do.
But you know, there's two things to that. Or let's say there's one, because there's a blessing and a curse within most things in life.
Of course.
And in this instance, the reason that my missus is gonna say all that stuff is because she doesn't have any road in her at all. If she was road, she would know. When your man calls you.
You don't have to be rolled, man.
You have to have some savage about you.
No, and she has another, you just listen to your man.
You have no.
It's in the tone of voice.
Sometimes
it's completely in the tone of voice. Like it's about you being able to know, actually, you know what? He don't talk to me like this normally. For him to be talking like this, there's a reason for it. I'm gonna have to trust him. That's all it is. That is all it is. There's no, you don't have to be rolled at all.
You want your woman to trust you? You expect to trust from your woman? I think if my woman was rolled, then she would be more.
If she knew you was involved in certain things, then it might be different.
If that conversation, like you said, my man is not that kind of man. But if his tone is different, if he's all abrupt about it, man is not, what's up, babe, I love you, blah, blah, blah. It's, hey, get the daughter, get something, and leave.
Mm-hmm.
Take the big car, the fast car, mm-hmm. You get me, and mm-hmm. go. And if she's about that life, she would just do it. And it's like, I know something's happening. I'll wait for the second call
and find out later. Yeah,
yeah, I think women about that life.
Dad will come back home and she will be cooking in the kitchen.
Yeah,
look about. I didn't leave it.
Yeah, I said the difference. Well, I didn't say this, but we've had this conversation before because I don't know. This is where I'm talking about having some sort of PTSD or something, because I'm not a road man and I haven't lived a road life. But because I grew up in a ghetto, I've told this woman that this situation could. If I ever do this, because I know what type of woman you are, just please, just do as I say. Please. I've had this conversation.
I've had the conversation as well. It didn't work. But I don't know what is happening. I don't know whether I need to do this. Or do I need to pack this? Do I need to take this? Do I need to, I said to her, I didn't give you any of those details, did I? I said to you to leave.
And go. How about if the roles were reversed?
Yeah, but what do I need? What do I need to take? What do I need to leave?
I am the defender.
You know what?
But how if the roles were reversed? I know that you're the defender, but if your missus called you and said, look, Stav, get our daughter and leave.
I would leave.
And she asked me as well. And I said, mm-hmm. I would leave. And I told her why. I said, because you don't normally talk like that. Mm. One.
Mm-hmm.
Two, for you to have rung and said to leave, it must be damn serious.
Mm.
And three, it's out of character completely.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. I'll drop my daughter off though. And then I'm waiting for them coming back. Something has to happen, didn't it?
You're dropping your daughter off where?
My sister doesn't live too far from me. I'll drop her off there.
And they're not coming back.
My sister lives down the road.
She's telling you to go to a certain place. Let's say that. Go to Uncle Kofi's in flipping Reading. Go there.
Then it's a bit like, why is it I have to go there?
No, it might be.
I can understand leaving the house.
It might be. She might have news of an atomic bomb that's coming in London, innit?
Then tell me, innit? Okay, you don't have that extra 10 seconds to say.
I'll buy my time.
Because then exactly. There's other people I have to call when I'm in the car. I have to call my mum, I have to call my sister, I have to call my brother. Boy. You get me?
Maybe she
I have to call you, man. I have to do a WhatsApp call, like one of them group calls, like I'll call the Slackfest group and do a group call. get out of London.
Webster's not on, on WhatsApp, but he'll be finished.
I forgot to even tell him that we recorded today.
You see?
This is what happens when you leave the ether. You leave the ether, man. That's your and that was his choice as well. This is his choice to leave.
You know, this going off this thing yesterday. I was in my parents yesterday, yeah, and they said a story that was making me laugh. So my mom said that she just had my sister. Right, so she just had my sister, so she was very tired, very weak. And my dad, being the nice husband that he is, told my mom, you know, go and rest, blah, blah, blah. And he would look after whatever's going on. So she went to bed and then she fell asleep. And then I think it was the night time and then he fell asleep. This is when they was living in an estate in Hackney back in the day. Well, we still live in an estate, but this is a proper like estate. Yeah.
Flats estate.
Yeah. And then he's on the ground floor. So anyway, mama said that she came down the stairs. No, my dad said he's going to clear up the house. That's what he said. He was going to clear up the house. So then, go to bed. So then when she came downstairs and then came out of a room because there was no downstairs, I don't think, at this time.
So there's two kids, by the way, at the time then.
And she came in the kitchen and she saw newspapers on the floor, like newspapers placed like in different like steps, these different pieces of newspaper, and then the window was open. And she was like, what's going on here? Blah, 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 blah. And then she said that she walked into the front room. She started calling my dad's name and he wasn't answering, whatever. Then she walked into the front room and then she saw that the television was gone. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then this is the most Nigerian thing. And I'm going to say what she said. And I want to hear what you think about my dad responded back with. Yeah. So my mom obviously saw that the TV was missing. Mm-hmm. So she called my dad's name again. Eventually he woke up and she goes to him, dad,
husband.
Yeah. Husband. Yeah. Where's the television?
I smoked the TV.
What do you think that my dad's response was as a Nigerian?
It's on my head.
Almost exactly the same thing. It's in bed with me here. What do you think? What do you think the television?
He said what?
He said it's in bed with me here. What do you mean the television? What was the television? Why are you asking where the television is? And then obviously she told him. And then obviously then she told him that the television, somebody stole the television. Then he came down, looked around, and seen that the television was gone, and blah, blah, blah. And then when they went to the police said to them, oh, you live on the ground floor of this estate. Right, and they haven't robbed you yet. That's what they said. That is what they said. But when I heard that, I said, that is the most Nigerian thing. It's either on your head or something in that region. It's in bed with me here. Why are you asking me this?
That's the classic, is, yeah.
It's on my head.
Oh, man.
And then I used to look for something and ask my mum, where is it? And it's on my head. Why did I ask?
And they might even know where it is.
And they might know as well. More time.
They just want to be causing grief unnecessarily.
Wait. All right.
Going back your boy, fam.
Derrick Jaxn. We have to talk about this dude. I knew nothing about him. Simple. Have you heard of this dude now?
Yeah, I've heard of him.
Did any of you know about him before? Well, outside of Mr. Wolf, who apparently has spoke about him on the podcast before and knows about his videos and whatever. Did you know about him, Simple, before?
Prior to this, no, I didn't know about
him. And what, Hala, you didn't know about him?
No.
I didn't know about him either.
I don't trust them man anyway, still.
No.
Yeah, I mean, he's a relationship expert, apparently.
In comments.
Yeah, he is a man who is a social media relationship expert, say that in inverted commas, a author of books and a individual who empowers women.
Can I ask you a question? Why is it an inverted commas?
Because
it's true, you know. All right, no, it was me that because it's me that said it.
Yeah, no, I say that in inverted commas because I think that when you are given a certain level of advice, I don't think that you should have hypocritical behaviors and also. I mean, for me, I always thought that he was a little bit
disingenuous
is the word I was looking for, and based on that is why I would say that.
I don't know if hypocritical behaviors is something that you can put into.
Yeah, you can
because as a parent, you're a hypocrite.
Perhaps. I mean, it's just like I remember when some people would apply to be. A bank clerk or someone who's a member of the bank, and if you had bad credit, you can become a bank clerk. So they consider you can't give financial advice if you can't handle your own finances. So I get that, but some people will look at that and think, you know, I'm not sure that you are in a position to be able to give this kind of advice when you yourself.
It depends on the advice, though.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
not
think,
really. If the advice is right, it's right.
No, but I'm saying it could be like a case of I'm bad in relationships. Don't do what I'm doing. These are the things I do that I think is bad. Maybe trying to avoid men like me. That could be a relationship advice. That could be potentially good.
But that's not the kind of angle that he was at.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I don't know what angle he was going for. I don't know this guy. Sorry for this guy.
I don't know this man. Yeah, nah, his angle was, you know, almost like I'm squeaky clean. Look at the way how I am living my life.
Look at my life. Did he say that? Because man didn't even claim his wife from look what I heard.
Nah, but he didn't say that verbatim. But that was the impression that he was giving out, innit?
Or that he wasn't married?
No, that he, I'm this stand-up guy. I'm the kind of guy that you need to be looking for.
Well, fair is.
You understand?
Does he match the Kevin Samuels book of what a man should be like?
No.
I don't know. I haven't.
I mean, I just saw through his bullshit. That's all. I think that a lot of the time he did empower women, you know, just try to tell them to believe in themselves, love yourself and, you know, find yourself first and things like that. But in terms of... I always said back then, I remember saying this specifically back then, is that I never at one stage saw him, or what I got from him is that he was very much knocking the black man. You know, that there's basically no good black men out there.
And we know you hate that.
I don't like that. I think that there's some fantastic men out there. You understand? And some of them are underneath your nose.
Can I ask you a question? It's a bit of a deep one about the same Derrick Jaxn guy. Because you said that you saw through him.
Yeah.
And you kind of knew that it was a Jean-Luc Foucault that he was putting up there.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Can I ask you a little bit deeper now, yeah? Would you say that you could see him being an abuser type?
Yeah. I mean, the videos... The funny thing is that he got caught out. He kind of denied it. And then he got to the point where he had to admit the fact that...
What? Because people don't know what he's...
He's been cheating on his wife multiple times with multiple people.
Oh, wow. He's multiple?
Multiple, yeah.
For about 14 years.
Yeah, multiple times with multiple people. And one of them apparently got pregnant and she decided not to have the child.
I don't understand why people get married.
You know.
It's not possible. That's what he has said. That's one of the things that he said. He said, if you don't get married... Stay single and bang around, isn't it? And let that woman be with somebody else.
I just don't get it. Like
that's I think that's one of the exact quotes that he used. Don't be in relationship if you can't be if you can't be faithful, you know, that you're waste and you're this, you're that, you're a nonsense guy and blah blah blah.
The tax write-offs are not worth it. In fact, I don't even know what they are. I don't even know if I've got any.
Some people don't go into it to cheat, though. Some people, they're looking to be faithful.
That's their intentions.
Nah, I don't. Some men have been cheating before the wedding, and then get married. They say, yeah, I'm not going to cheat anymore, man. And then as soon as they see vagina again, they're cheating.
Can I say one thing?
Go on.
They're crying in the water.
Did you finish your question?
No, so that the question was whether you could see him as an abuser.
Yeah. Because in the video, sorry, I was getting somewhere, is that he was sitting with his wife in the video and it just looked really uncomfortable.
People were saying it was uncomfortable in the sense where, oh, how did he just come and drag his wife onto the stage, blah, 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 blah. But I'm saying, and I think you're saying the same thing, uncomfortable in a sense where she looked afraid.
No, a lot of people were saying that.
Enough people said
that. Okay. That's why I kept saying that. People were saying that she looked like she was done with her will of doing it.
Yeah.
Like he pushed her to do it.
Yeah.
Even the meme that, the first thing I ever knew about this dude was that meme that was sent into the group and I had no idea what does this mean. And it says, blink twice if you need help.
If you need help. Yeah.
And for me, it's like, out of context, that means nothing to me. Within context now, it made sense because it was a clip of the video of him with his missus.
The way he was holding her hand, the way the hand was halfway over him rather than, she just looked completely uncomfortable. He was dragging her around like with her hand. I was looking at it and I was like, this is unbelievable. This is like real abuse in front of us.
She came with a bonnet as well, boy. No woman don't come on the TV in a bonnet like that still.
Yeah, you know.
Look like he just dragged her from the front.
Yeah, a black woman with bonnet on TV. That's going into the internet. And he never should have put her on as well. Because all of his videos, I don't see him wearing a ring. Well, I remember, like I said, I don't know about him. But I have been following it in the last week, so I ain't gonna lie. Apparently, he doesn't wear a ring. He doesn't really claim that he had a missus. People didn't know. Yeah, so if you read the comments in the thing, it's like, is he even married? Or he's going to make somebody a wonderful wife one day, like a husband one day. And then the odd person will be like, I think he has a woman. But it's, I think. So he doesn't, like, you know me, and you hear us on the pod, you know our status.
Yeah, well, we claim
our partners if we have them. Yeah. And then we don't. So that is what it is.
I even claimed my wife to a prostitute.
Oh yes, that's true. He did do that.
Mm-hmm. Good days.
In abroad.
I'm married.
I'm married.
Not even married, but I'm married.
I went to go show her a picture, boy. No long thing.
This is my wife. Oh, she's very nice, but she's in Brazil.
I'm talking about Cuba, bro.
Cuba.
I didn't quite get what you were saying.
Yeah. Anyway. Wasn't him in the club again?
Oh, man. A prostitute approached you and you told her that you're married.
And then I showed her a picture of...
Because she was very forceful about it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because she told me I didn't like black women as well. That's what kicked it off.
Yeah, that is true. Yeah, she said, you don't like black?
You don't like black?
So I went to go show her. RK, what was this thing? He was crying, man. He's like, I can't believe you're doing this. Because, yeah, I'm doing it. I'm probably vexed at all black. Tell me I don't like black women. I'm marrying a black woman telling me I don't like black women. Are you mad?
Anyway, go on.
Then she took out her breast.
I just said that. I watched... literally. And I missed it, man.
Yes! And then I ran away.
I love our lives.
Oh, you retreated.
You know how many women I've run away from abroad?
Yes.
It's a lot, you know.
I like your black.
A lot.
Shout out
52 weeks later. If he tells you about the time I was running from the woman in Sweden, what white woman was chasing me around the club?
Was it in the ice bar or something?
That was a different bar, but it was somewhere in Sweden.
I seen him run from Arties in Coventry.
I ran from bare women in the past in my life, boy. Otherwise, me, they want to be aggressive.
They like that big meat, man.
Yeah, but they have to be aggressive with it, though.
Yeah, at their age, man. At your age.
Oh, man.
Yeah, sorry. I don't know this Derrick guy.
You guys, you need to help me.
What's that?
Because I could go to hell. Because nobody that takes this much pleasure from somebody's downfall can go to heaven.
What, for the Derrick guy?
I'm enjoying it.
But why? You say you don't even know who he is.
That's it. Huh?
You say you don't even know who he is.
Because like I said, you can see he's a fraud from the jump. You can see he's a fraud. So I don't know what his fraudulent status is, but it's under the fraud status. He's not in.
Is he Michael Bodden, wherever you're fraud?
He's not. I don't know that dude.
Michael Bodden.
He's the one that went out with women and was...
Fleecing them the money.
Yeah, but all I saw was what women were writing about him, innit?
What's his name of the song?
I enjoy his song as well.
Yeah, it was a good song.
For him, and that's a different subject. This one is going out of his way to talk about X, Y, Z while he's doing A, B, and C. And you can see he's a fraud.
I don't like that type of man. If you're going to be honest with yourself, be honest with yourself. What I don't like is, for me, it's a bit like when people mislead old people. Well, you know that, especially black women at the moment, you see that they're going through a situation where they feel unloved and unwanted. And you're basically feeding off that to build your status.
That's the thing.
So, and you're making it worse for them. So now they're going to be feeling like they can't trust black men again.
The reason I'm calling him a fraud is not because I think he's doing something at home. I don't know whether he had a missus or, like I said, I didn't know anything until after anyways. But if I watch a video of him, I don't know if he's faithful to his woman or not. That's not the issue. The issue is what is coming out of his mouth. He's saying it for clout. He's saying it because he wants to sell a book or whatever. He don't mean what he's saying. Mm. That's the fraudness that I'm talking about.
Some people might say that about us, though.
They can say what they want anyways. I'll talk for myself. I'm not even going to talk for you guys. What I say, what I mean what I say, and I follow through. So when I say that, if a man come with a shank, what are you doing? And I said, I'm running, I'm leaving you, man. Well, I don't see why you think I'm like...
People have said that about us.
Said what? That we're frauds?
Yeah, who is it? That one of them, somebody on Twitter was calling us frauds, isn't it? One time that we panned out a lot to women. Forget what his name is, but he was calling himself Podfather, if I remember rightly. And it was saying that was pandering to women. Even Mr. Wolf slightly says I pander to women at times when he's saying.
It seemed like one of our own boys was saying something similar. Maybe it seemed like it was going down that
Mr.
road.
Mr. Wolf didn't deny it though; he just laughed
because it's true.
Defenders of the earth, defenders.
So you don't think I'm actually being
pandering means you mean one thing, but you're saying something else.
Okay. I retract the word pandering.
See?
Yeah. But what I did say last week, or was it the week before, I said that you wouldn't be cancelled if everybody could see the WhatsApp group.
Yeah, but
because I said that you're genuine, that women understand and like what you have to say. Do you understand? So pandering may not be the correct word.
People.
But I understand why women are feeling big wahala, and I don't think it's pandering. It's just...
I don't see how people can say that stuff about me. The amount of things I've said on this podcast. So they were saying that about you?
No, I said no one should be saying that. I think it was actually talking about you that time. Exactly. But I don't see how anyone could be saying that about you.
I've said lots of stuff that people would find issues with. I'm more likely to get problems from women saying I don't like what you said.
If it was big enough to be cancelled, you would have been cancelled by now.
If I was big enough to be cancelled, I don't think so.
With all the hair talk, you would have been.
I think you'd have been cancelled.
Yeah, man.
They would have taken you.
Nah, I don't think so.
It wouldn't have been necessary, but you would have been cancelled.
Because I said you should have your natural hair.
Yeah.
Why do you feel
because
like
it's the way that you have it?
Week.
I'm sorry, it's the way that you say it.
I don't think I'd be cancelled for that.
Okay.
Because you can't defend that.
Okay. That's what you're saying, that is enough for them to
want
to cancel.
Can you defend?
Let's not get into it because I love you as a brother. I don't want you to be cancelled. Right,
no, it's not because you don't, just don't want to go down that road. I don't even want to have that conversation again. I'm taking immense pleasure from this man's downfall. The only thing, the little twinge and the little chip on this is that
his
wife is in the middle of it, and I don't want to see her getting dragged. And unfortunately,
she's
getting it.
And I don't understand why this is the problem I have with people. When men do something wrong, why do they always still go and attack the wife at the same way? Maybe I think she might have said a few things that people didn't like, or because she didn't go gung-ho into killing the man or whatever. Now everything's on her case. But I don't understand it. A lot of things, when men do something wrong, the wife seems to have to be attacked by association. I don't think it's the same way the other way around.
With this woman's particular case, and again, this might be out of pocket, but I'm taking it from, because I saw that video as well, the one where he was confessing or whatever.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I was really uncomfortable when I was watching that. And then apparently I heard that, I don't really follow these people on social media, but I heard that her social media, people were kind of worried about some of her messages over the last couple
She seems a bit...
Yeah, that she's not all there.
Not even so much that she's not all there, but like that she might be in a precarious situation where she is a hostage. Do you get what I'm saying to you?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So they were saying that even her messages were a bit worrying. And so I'll be honest with you, I didn't see the humor that everybody else seemed to see. In that interview, I was quite uncomfortable, and I was like, boy, this, what we're seeing here, as far as I'm concerned, is somebody who is the victim of abuse is in broad daylight in front of us, and we're being distracted by all of these other things.
Mm-hmm.
Even the way he presented himself, this idea of talking about himself in the third person.
He was responding to that video. So whilst he was responding to the video of him and his wife, that was him responding in the third person,
but
which was very strange.
That kind of language allows you cognitively to disassociate yourself
mm-hmm.
with
the actual situation.
Yeah. So I don't know if his name is actually Derrick Jaxn or if that's a moniker. That would help me to explain why he could potentially talk in the third person to that degree and it be even remotely sensible.
Mm.
But outside of that, like, there's a lot of things that's worrying for me. Like, you're talking about yourself in the third person the way he's doing it, because we do it sometimes. Like, oh, man says that's talking in the third person, or Simple Simon says that's talking in the third person. But he is talking literally like
this is another person.
Like,
it's not him.
Have you seen that video we're talking about?
Which one?
There's the one where he's commenting on himself.
Yeah, I didn't watch all of it. He's
a sociopath.
So I got part way through it, and I thought there's something wrong with this guy.
I never watched more than like a minute of his videos, all of them, including the one where he's apologizing. But the thing with that one was, so remember, his thing is he sits in his car, apparently outside of the woman that he's cheated the house, because somebody said that's the same house.
Different houses, yeah.
So he sits in his car and he plays a clip of, well, this is what I've seen, so maybe he does other things, but he plays a clip of something and then he comments on it. And the clip is, so it's usually half screen.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's listening to the clip
mm-hmm.
and you can see him shaking his head or whatever, or smiling or whatever it is. And then when the clip ends, he makes his comment.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he did the same thing with his own My Apology video or whatever.
That's actually quite smart.
And for me, the thing was, I thought somebody had just edited it. Because I didn't think he could, like you said about being a sociopath, once the video stopped, he said, well, I don't, I respect that man for being honest and at least, well, blah, blah, blah. And I'm thinking, that can't be real. Somebody must have just taken that video.
And spliced it.
Yeah. Until he carried on. And then he said some things that were identifiable with that. And I was like, this man is a madman. He's a madman.
Properly.
Yeah. Did you watch the video that Yom's posted? The donkey of the week on...
I did actually, yes.
That was quite poignant.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Charlemagne made him donkey of the day on his radio show. And because the thing is, he's gone in on Charlemagne because Charlamagne, has admitted to cheating.
No, Charlamagne said that he cheats all the time, man. He's saying he was cheating for years.
Yeah, he said he's just stopped to it in 2016.
Yeah, something like that.
Because he's gone on their podcast, or the Brilliant Idiots, they went in on, for the first hour, near enough, they went in on him. And he's like, basically saying the similar things that we're saying. They didn't bring up the abuse thing, actually, but they brought up the fact that this man is a fraud.
A narcissist.
And because the reason I'm happy to go in on you is because you were so big with, I don't forgive people and I don't give them no leeway when they cheat. They don't deserve any leeway. So now you've done the same thing and you've got caught out. You are not getting any leeway because you came out all of us, mans. You were trying to tarnish all of us. So now it's my turn. I'm going to have fun with it. And they had fun with it. They demolished him. So he did a 15-minute rant almost on his radio show talking about him. And the thing is, he played his own clips against him.
He destroyed him.
One kept playing his own clips.
One thing you can say about Charlamagne, you can hate him for this, you can hate him for that, but he's quite honest when he talks. That's why people hate him, because he says things that is on his brain.
But he destroyed him in that Donkey of the Day, though. He really went in. Everything that a lot of people maybe had their views on him was aired out on that clip.
I'm interested, Mr. Wolf. You said that there are still people that you're talking to, women, that are backing him.
Yeah.
They need to keep hope alive, bruv.
One of my previous relationships, so I wouldn't, it doesn't specifically say...
Why did you just say something? Well,
he said what he said, though.
I said what I said.
That's
it. Yeah, but
it was one of my previous relationships. That lady, I remember we had a proper back and forth. I wouldn't say so much of an argument, but it was a debate about this individual, about this guy. And I was just saying that the guy's not genuine, you know what I mean? That I can see through him, and I gave my reasons for that. And it was similar to what a lot of people were saying to me, women in particular, that, nah, man, this guy is good for women. You know, this whole act like a man or think like a man, or this Steve Harvey book, you know, telling the secrets of a man, you know, that's what they were saying, that you guys are upset because he's giving away the secrets of the players out there. And I was saying, nah, it's got nothing to do with that. It's just that you can see right through his BS, that what he's doing it for likes and follows. And obviously, you know, he's a good looking man. He's in great shape and he's not doing it for the right reasons, in my opinion.
He's doing it to get more vagina.
Basically, innit?
Can I get a
vagina?
The women that he seems to have cheated with, they didn't know about him in that capacity, though, from what I gather.
Yeah, nobody knew about him in that capacity.
And even blocked him on social media, so...
They didn't know he had a wife.
He was doing that for money.
Yeah, they didn't know he had a wife. They didn't know he was that way inclined. They didn't know he was particularly religious, because on his videos he comes across as God-fearing and all the rest of it. But they, in their experience of him, had no idea that
the first person that came out said that he said he had separated, that she left the house, and he flew her over to his crib. And she saw her paraphernalia all around the house, and it's like, yeah, because she's moving out.
He moved.
He banged her in the house. Yeah. In the marital home.
Bro. He banged her in the marital home.
First, he flew her to where he lived in Atlanta or something. He flew her to Miami first, and then banged her there. And then he flew her to his old home, and then banged her there.
He
buying plane tickets.
He's moving mad, bro.
That's what I'm saying. The money, because he wanted to show them.
Everybody makes mistakes, apparently. That's what I got in the past week, that, you know, he shouldn't be crucified because of the mistakes.
Let me tell you something, because
of the mistakes that he's made. But, you know, that did go into another conversation about if you cheat on your partner, should you automatically end the relationship? And I think that he had cheated multiple times, and I think that person was saying that doesn't mean that his relationship with his wife should end.
But that's people that believe in marriage heavily will say that, though. In regards to this type of situation, for me, it's just the same thing as when you have a girlfriend or a wife or somebody, and there's one random guy that you know is just not genuine with your wife or your girlfriend, and you know that man is there for a particular reason, and you tell your wife or your girlfriend, watch that one, you know. You try not to get too, because there's people that will be overly whatever, but there's certain man that's cool, and they'll just say, you know what, watch Tim, because Tim blatantly on it, you know. And they will swear to you. They will fight you over Tim.
No, Tim's just my friend. I've known him for time, and he's cool. That's the one you don't have to worry about.
Then there's either you break up with said girl, and then two twos later you see her with Tim. What happened with Tim?
Yeah. Oh, okay. You know what that sounded like? You know when golden axe when you kill someone? That's like,
You stay with the woman, and then later on, you don't see Tim anymore. And you ask, you just be like, what happened to Tim? Because there's no way, because you don't really pay attention to
him. Oh, he tried it on me.
What happened to Tim? Oh, yeah, you know, I don't really chat to Tim no more. Mm-hmm. I got a vibe from him that he was blah, blah, blah. Oh, you got a vibe, did you?
Yeah.
Oh, you got a vibe. Yeah, all right, yeah, no way, love. It's cool.
I've had that one before.
And that's the thing is that some men play the long game. They will wait 6 months.
A woman will never tell you as well.
24
You're not allowed
months,
to be right in that situation. That's what I'm saying.
They'll wait 2-3 years until, you know, maybe the man slips up or, you know, the relationship is not as strong as it was, and then they'll take advantage of that situation.
This is what I tell my female friends. If you are courting a man, don't bring him to your girls. Yeah, bring him to me. Because a man will tell you straight away that man is not legit. Mm. He's not kosher. He's not halal.
Yeah, but you have to have that boy that's not going by man code, isn't it? Because the man code is you don't talk about an ex. The same way that we're complaining about this Derrick guy, if he was actually genuine, we would still be complaining, like, why is he going around just abusing men, blah, blah, blah. Right? Certain men will be still be saying, why is he talking about other men? Even if what he's saying is correct, they'll be like, well, why is he talking about other men? It's man code. Same thing they will say with this. So there's some man you can't take around because the man code is more important than your brethren.
Well, a woman, if you have a man and he's your bona fide and you trust him, he's not trying to get in your pants and he's honest enough to that you believe him. It's more in your interest to bring your new man or your new prospective man around him than around your girls, because he will be able to tell you straight. This man is not. I've done it with my people, and I just tell them, and then I leave it. I don't force the issue because that is the man rule. Yeah, it's like I tell you, and I leave it as that.
What do you think of man?
I've done that recently.
Mm-mm. And then when you come back later, because I'm the king of I told you so. Oh, I told you so. I told you.
See, I wouldn't even do that. I'll tell him. I'll say.
One of my good friends is in a relationship, and I've told her that you're wasting your time with this brother. You know, I've told her once, I told her twice, and that is it.
Once, twice, three times a lady.
You know, she's a good girl, man, but I know that this brother is not.
He's not serious, isn't he? So you can see a not serious guy from a mile away.
Because men can see men the way I'm assuming women can see other women.
This bare time just happened with us, and we just look at him and like, listen. That guy's not serious, you know. But if that's what you're on, then that's what you're on, innit? But you got to tell him that.
And that's the same thing with Derrick Jaxn. So seeing him, you just get that vibe. You tell people, this guy don't really get your advice from this one. You get me? Maybe from, because it's not, one of them said, oh, it's because he's good looking, you're hating. I'm like, you know, I think I'm all right, innit? It's got nothing to do with the good
sweet
looks
boy
and all of that. There's a couple other guys who are good looking guys, you know what I'm saying? Like these are sweet boys. Some of them are rough looking. These are good looking guys in good shape. And the information that they're sending out, I'm like, yeah, I'm feeling that, brother. I'm feeling what he said about man and about women. He's all right. But my man over here.
But he's not real. Sorry.
Mr. Jaxn, he is not a real brother. So don't be too inner his information.
All right, let's switch this up then, yeah?
Looking like a crumb.
Have you ever had a woman that you've had, yeah, and you've taken to another woman and they've said,
No, because I'm always right. So,
wow.
If I had a woman that I've taken to another woman and she's gone, no.
Nah, not that one, fam.
I've had a woman and the brothers have said no.
No, I'm talking about the woman.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the woman.
I'm always right with women. And I'm always right with men.
I'm saying that you took it to a woman, like one of your bridges.
No.
And even your sister or someone is like, nah.
Oh, okay. The woman I was engaged to.
Oh, yeah, you got it from everyone.
Everybody said that I shouldn't be with her.
Even before.
Even the family told you. Their old family told you that you shouldn't be with that one.
Yeah, but it wasn't that I didn't know. It was that I
saw.
Yeah, I loved it, but I just didn't care. I don't know how to explain it.
Even before the love came, bruv.
No, it wasn't before the love. Love came very early with that one.
Alex told you one time before you even like fell in love.
The reason I spoke to him was because I was already like
infatuated.
It was
infatuation, bruv.
I don't know what it was, man. You know what it was?
It was lust.
You know them when them forgive the term because my ex fiance is not a hoe, but them save a hoe complex. The time I fell for that woman not in love, but just fell for her or got was infatuated. Well, she had a big beef with somebody on, I think it was over the phone, and what, and I had this save this woman complex, and I swooped in with my cape. Is everything all right? Can I do anything for you? And
make puss.
And please, ma'am, a little pom pom,
a little pussy.
Is everything all right?
A little pussy for the road.
And she reciprocated the I don't know whatever I was pushing out
was on the floor, and then she reached her hand for you to grab her.
Yes, and I grabbed her and I pulled her.
Are you okay, man?
And instead of pulling her up, she pulled me down. But that's what happened with that. Because I can vividly remember that day. She had an argument with somebody, and I didn't, because we had worked together for months before then, or weeks. I don't know how long it was. I did not notice that woman until then. I didn't notice her until she had that beef, that big bust up, and then it's like, I need to save this woman.
So gravitated towards pain.
Yeah, your complex came in, and you felt like you needed to save her.
Yeah. Rago.
Okay, fair enough.
Rago, I ain't going to lie to you.
Everyone just saw you walking towards fire, but no one could save you.
Kane.
I was thinking about it, Wala. I think my mum did it to me one time.
I told you about a woman, yeah?
Yeah,
she right?
I don't know if she was right or not.
Are you with a woman now?
No, but that wasn't the reason.
Oh, it was a bad thing that left.
It was a, yeah, kind of like, it was just like, yeah, not that one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sometimes things just don't work out.
Mm. And she doesn't normally tell me that kind of thing, but she was like, yeah.
I don't like that. I don't like that.
But a lot of
it's always the
guys,
one with the wicked pom-pom. That
a lot of guys prefer Kevin Samuels.
Insane.
And not to say, I mean, I'm all about filter, innit? You know what I mean?
Ray Chash as well.
Yeah, but this is why I'm saying I'm all about filter, because not everything that these people say is the gospel. I mean, what's his name? Say some things that are co-signed, Dr. Umar Johnson, but some of the stuff that he says is absolute, utter nonsense. Mm. You get me? So
that one needs a black alpha African American male right there. A Caucasian can't handle a woman like that right there.
Yeah, that's Dr. Umar.
Donations.
But Kevin Samuels.
That's how we sounded like when we were talking about Patreon. Donations.
Kevin Samuels. The reason why
envelopes.
I don't mind him per se, because he goes straight to the bone with the comments that he's making, which can be uncomfortable, but he's getting straight to the bone marrow, the pain. Get to the crux of the situation, and the point of view will be made a lot clearer. But I like him a lot because he's got the same energy for men and women. You get me? He's looking to call out men. He's looking to call out women.
The
you know what I mean? Whereas my man is just, you know, he's just a feed of information to get that pussy.
I saw one video where he was cutting a woman.
Who?
The Derrick Jaxn one. Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't see many. So when, because I heard what you said, that
I'd say a majority then.
Maybe, yeah, because I didn't watch many. And I saw one. So I said, if it was one out of five and he was cutting a woman, I'd say, well, there's them decent stats there, 20%.
The thing about Kevin Samuels was that they called him to ask questions. That's the, they didn't call him, you want to talk to them. So that's their own problem. You calling him to ask him something, he's telling you what he thinks, isn't it? If you don't call him, he can't tell you.
The reason I comment on these people is because they put themselves in the predicament or the position where I am the person that can give advice.
Position.
So once you say that and you're wrong, then I'm quite happy to say you're chatting fraff.
Yeah, if you are just
on a podcast and somebody asks a question, or we're just having a general chit chat now and somebody's saying this is their opinion, then cool. It's not, I don't have to go so ham on you. But if it's this is my thing, this is how I make my money, my business is to tell you about X, Y, and Z. When X, Y, and Z is wrong, then I'm quite happy to tell you you're chatting fraff.
Business. This is my business.
So that's why.
That's why you're not putting yourself up there for it. Yeah, for the role.
Well, my missus has told me, because we've had this conversation before, where she said she doesn't want me to keep using our relationship as some sort of standard and
benchmark,
and bigging her up all the time, because anything can happen. Like, things can fall. I said we are not gonna fall. I don't even live the life of.
She didn't want to be the wife that's you're holding there in the video. That's why.
When this thing happened, because she said
we're the player watching.
When I mentioned this Derrick Jaxn, she said, "Oh, the good looking dude." That's how she described.
What's so good looking about this dude?
I don't know, but that's how she described him. Then that is what made me interested in this dude. If I'm gonna be honest with you about this, that's why I said, because
you want to see what your wife.
I would not pay no mind to him otherwise. But when I brought up that this person, and she's like, "Oh yeah, the good looking dude." That's her description of him. I'm like, okay, let me see. isn't it? Yeah, when I see musical looking dude, and she likes henchmen. He's hench. He's too, for me, he's too big. She likes the muscly man in it.
What's his name?
Derrick Jaxn.
But and he spells it
J-A-X-N, Hartley. So
fucking hell.
What was my point again?
Google better find it the way I spell it then.
You can't. He's Jack's.
Yeah, he's trending now, man. You're just putting Derrick into Google. It's probably filling the rest for you.
You mean this motherfucker?
Yeah. This one right here. Yeah. That's what women like, man. My wife, when it comes to like fancying men, she's not one of them quirky, you know. Nah, she likes what most black women like, or the traditional what black women like. That Negro there.
She likes the warrior looking types. The one that look like it can take on panthers and shit.
Look at his eyes in this video, man.
I forgot my point now.
Look at his face.
The fact that your missus thought he was good looking. She's, and that's the reason why.
This is exactly why she doesn't want us talking about, or doesn't want me talking about us. Because of, look how everybody's going on him. Even me and her were giggling at each other about this. She's like, I don't ever want that to be us. So just keep your mouth closed about our relationship. So it is what it is.
Are you ever going to hold your woman hostage? You know. I don't think that could ever be you, bro.
It can't be me. This can't, that situation, but this, so people say never.
No, I think you can say never.
I can't. For me, I couldn't do that to my missus. It's not a thing of, I don't see women and want to bang. If any man tells you that, he's chatting fraff.
Every day.
Yeah. So I'll tell my wife. I will see a woman.
You just don't act on
I can't do that to my wife. Yeah. It's nothing to do. So it's not even a selfish thing. It's not even I'm high and mighty thing. It's just that woman I love too much. I can't do that to my wife. I couldn't do it to my child.
I'm going to send this to your wife, Steph.
No, which one?
Apparently, Derrick Jaxn used to be a chubster.
Chubster. Word up.
And no, it's cut. So I'm going to send it to say, this is what your husband could be if he loves you the way he should.
If he loves it as much as he says it.
Said it, she'll cackle over and laugh. All right, we got a few more things to talk about. We're already.
He has breast on this one as well, for real, boy.
Yeah. Well, it can happen anyways.
Cop them.
I want you guys, I definitely want to talk about this video from the Lil Nas X, because we were asked to talk about that. Shout out, Wavy. But in the meantime, because none of you have actually watched the video, in fact, let's discuss it. None of you might have seen the video. Mm. I watched it last night because Wavy sent it to me. Mm-hmm. Wavy said, I can't wait for the ESN guys to talk about this Lil Nas X-Wing. I said, what's going on? Because I knew nothing about it. I haven't been really on social media too hard this week. And he sent me the video. He said it comes with a warning. Bruv, I'm giving you a pre-warning. Mm. I watched the thing and I said this, I tapped his name and I see everybody talking about it. Why are people not afraid of God anymore? You know, what kind of, like, yeah, wow. Are the men just not afraid of God anymore? And what's going on? And blah, 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 blah. And I watched the video and I was like, I don't care. Like, it wasn't a big deal to me, but I was messaging back and I said, I could not send this to the man them group though. Because if I send that to them, somebody might kick me out of the group.
Somebody said that these men are doing blood ritual on it was Etsy that said it. So these men are just doing blood ritual and I was crying. I said, what is this now? All I saw was a little clip of the video of him riding the devil.
I want you men to watch the video whilst I talk about something else and let
I'm gonna play it now then.
What's it called?
It's in the group.
It's in the group there. I'll put it. It's the last thing in the questions group there. So do that. And I will...
Do I have to watch it?
Please, you don't have to, but then what are you going to talk about? I'm gonna find something to talk about on my own for the next 4 minutes. Or I can just cut this bit out, actually. In fact, we'll be back momentarily.
We bring in the studio this morning one of the gay rights activists, Mr. Should I call you Mr.? Pepe Julian Onzima, thank you for coming in.
Thank you for
good morning.
Me. Morning to you.
Why are you gay?
Who says I'm gay?
You are gay.
You finished?
Yeah, done.
All right, we are back. Bang, bang, bang.
It all started when you started wearing skinny jeans. That's why all this shit started happening. I'm joking before you.
No. It's for real, dog. You should have been like Ghost and Ray the other day with jeans hanging down your ass, which I don't like as well. But I know which one. Which one do you prefer? Man's wearing jeans that are so tight they can barely walk, or man's wearing jeans where it's hanging off their ass?
I don't understand the preference of both. I don't understand both.
I don't get either one.
I don't understand the ones that put it on that is so tight that I don't understand how they manage to get it on.
You don't get it on the same way the women do.
Yeah, but it's mad.
With powder.
You know that video of them in that picture that they keep sending around of those four boys? There was four white boys.
Yeah.
Like, their jeans are so tight.
What four white boys?
You ever seen these four white boys? They got
memed. They're just outside of a bar. And they're just...
By the muscly guys.
Yeah. Oh, they look like Johnny Bravo.
And people got accused of bullying them because they were innocent. Just took a picture and then they got... Yeah.
It's brilliant.
It is though. Imagine there's a picture of your kids, your son and his boys posted a picture of themselves online. None of them doing anything, no gang sign or nothing. People are just
posting outside. Just literally outside of a shop.
And then everybody's just ripping them. You wouldn't be happy with it. That, and then your son now has got issues. It's getting cussed at school.
Yeah, because they're saying that it's affecting their work, bro.
Roll your eyes all you want, but social. It's the same as if you went to school and people were ripping you for your clothes. It's the same. Imagine that times 10,000.
So them man are having personal problems.
It's
almost like you're famous now without even wanting to be.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You didn't ask for it.
And you're famous for something that you probably don't want to be famous for as well. It's not nice.
Like if we get ripped from something, we posted this thing out. We're looking for people to.
Why would you say that?
We're looking for people to listen to us.
Them Essex boys there. You get me? Them Essex boys tattooed off, muscled off.
Yeah.
You get me? Tight jeaned off, tight top off.
Alright.
You know, that's how they're rolling. And they post that picture.
They have the tops off, they had tops on.
No, I mean as in tight jeans off. You know, I don't mean off.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Carry on.
Everything a man says.
No, but you said your top off, so
now tight jeans off. Tight top off. It didn't mean off. That's just how you're saying.
No, he said top off. So when I thought you meant the top was
okay,
off.
Okay, man.
There's nothing wrong with what I'm saying. Yeah. I don't feel there's anything wrong with me saying that the man didn't have the top off. You just say that's not what I meant and be on with it. Why do you have to be?
So how come you didn't say about the trousers off then?
He did. No, he said wearing their tight jeans off. Yeah, I understood that. But then he said with their tops off.
No, I said tight top off.
I didn't hear tight. I just said the tops off.
Okay. So that's why we're
yeah. But then I said but they had their tops on. Then all you need to say to me was, I don't understand why people take things so far.
Bitch.
All they said to you was, I didn't mean that. Okay, I said, fine.
Yeah, bitch.
But no, you had to make it sound like I was causing some form of disturbance in life. But for me, if they had the tops off, I would understand them get people ripping them.
But does he have a big dick?
I would understand people ripping them. So that's why I said, I didn't have the tops off. Because if they had the tops off and it was pulling like that, I could understand.
Okay, they had their tops on. For people that haven't seen the picture, I don't know. All of them were wearing shirts or whatever.
Sorry, none
of them were topless.
Land, Mr.
You don't like to go against me. Against me.
Mr. Wolf, land, please. You're running out of aviation fuel. Land.
I like that. No, I'm just saying that when you put that out there, then expect for people to make comments about it. That kind of pose, that kind of picture, you're making a statement with that. And you are going to get some kind
what point
of...
Where? If you put on your personal Instagram that you think all your friends are going to look for...
Do we know for sure where they posted it?
They're not celebrities. They just posted it on a social media. It got picked up and it just got memed. It happens sometimes.
For me, I know it's rough or whatever.
I'm just saying that...
If they were getting compliments, we wouldn't be having the conversation. So.
Yeah, but the compliments is fine. Insulting people for not doing anything wrong. It's not that they weren't racist. They weren't beating people up. They did nothing to anybody from what we know.
It is bullying. If you like it or not, it's still bullying.
Yeah, you can tell a man up and just deal with it, or you can just, all right, well, it's bullying, innit? But it's social, innit? And just live with it. That's fine. But to just dismiss it as it's not bullying, it's not the case.
That goes with that Tyrion reefing that comes later as well, by the way.
Especially if it was a woman now, I don't know if you'd be saying that as well. Because maybe you might have a bit more sympathy for them. I hope you would anyways.
Black woman at that, Mr. Wolf.
It's bullying is bullying, man.
Black woman.
I'm saying that if that was for women who were maybe scantily dressed, I would expect a certain similar type of energy. It's just what happens.
I would look forward.
When you put things out for people to see. I've got my social media, I've got a personal social media that is locked. You get me? Yes, there is a possibility that someone could screenshot that picture and put it out there. I would be vexed about that. You get me? But the whole idea of, you know, people going to use a certain photograph and just make it go viral and then I'm going to be, you know, hiding in the streets because people are making comments about it. If that's how they feel, then that's how
it's
they feel,
it's affected their jobs and stuff. It's not like it's... That could affect your job.
Okay. All right,
it could easily affect your job, you especially.
But like I said, if they're dealing with things, then
I think you're more sensitive than sometimes.
Then I'm very sorry for it.
I don't think you would take too kindly at all.
If
a picture of you, an innocent picture of you, as far as you're concerned, because you said these Essex boys, you assumed they're Essex boys because of how they dress, because that's the point. That's how Essex boys dress. So it wasn't anything fantastical and magical. It was just how Essex boys dress on a Friday, Saturday night and go to a bar.
And they have it large.
They took a picture, not doing anything. They weren't throwing up, you know, gang signs or sniffing coke. It was just the four of them standing there,
having it large,
looking at the camera. And if somebody took a picture of you, and let's say it's just the four of us, and that's all it was. We're just standing outside here, took a picture, and we got ripped to shreds. Ripped to shreds. National newspapers, they're gunning us.
Your kids is coming back from school saying that they're getting cussed because of your dad.
You would not be saying...
You would not be happy.
Like, it's nothing, innit? I'm more likely to say, well, whatever, innit, than you. I actually truly believe
if
that.
If that's what you believe, then that's truly fine, believe bro. That. Well, I'm saying that you're wrong, innit? If that's how you see me to be more sensitive than you, man, then that's fine.
I don't think anybody is as sensitive as Steph. But I don't think in this situation you're gonna just be blanking that off. I don't think so. I think you'll be annoyed and vexed especially you just got a quite heavy and high regard for respect for yourself. If you think that people are just out here disrespecting you willy-nilly, you would not accept that.
I wouldn't really care for people that don't know me.
Okay.
You get me?
But the thing is, it's going to be people that you know.
Yeah, so if my people that I have an affiliation to and they are the ones that are disrespecting me, then that is where I will be maybe sensitive in inverted commas is what you're talking about. But if it is a bunch of strangers, then I don't particularly care.
Bro. I'm not arguing against you. What I will say, though, is the reality of that situation is a lot greater than the theoretical argument.
Where did it stem from again?
Lil Nas X.
Okay, yeah, we've watched the video. What do you guys think?
I just think it's foolishness. But it is what it is. It's just for people. It's for us to not. That's why I tried not to speak about these things because he's doing it for me to speak about it.
Yeah, this is his biggest. The fastest he's ever got to 1 million views. Is this video?
Yeah,
taking into account he had one of the biggest. Well, not one of. He had the biggest song ever.
But he's trying to. Go on, sorry.
I think it's part of a PR campaign, though.
Yeah, because he's selling a pair of Nikes that's got blood meant to be blood infused or something.
Apparently, real blood in it.
Real blood.
Yeah. I don't know if this is like a WhatsApp theory or whatever.
Of course, it's not real blood.
I said that because my wife told me, and I looked at her. And I said, "This is Facebook, innit?" I was like, "This is only your Facebook thing that's gone around viral now." I've seen real blood. Was it signed to somebody from
Nigeria?
Yeah, something, because it can't be. You cannot put real blood in somebody's shoe and sell it. Not Nike. No way.
No, but it's not coming from Nike. The shoe was bought from Nike, and then one of those custom outfits. Who?
So it's like a single pair.
MSCF. Confirmed that the Air Max 90 shoes are bought independently and customized by its artist. So
okay,
it wasn't a Nike endorsed.
It's meant to be a Satan shoe, like 666. There's only 666 pairs of them.
Yeah, and it's got a pentagram on in there as well.
Okay, all right. So that's a press release, isn't it?
Yeah, that's basically it's all PR.
Yeah,
and the thing that made me know it or suspect it is that 2 days ago, 2 days before this video dropped, all of a sudden he was trending on Twitter, and people were saying, "Oh, this song is so great. This song is so lit. This song is so great. This song is so lit." And I was just like, "What are you talking about?" I played the song, and I was like, okay, this song is not all that. Like, it's not all that for the noise that's being made.
Mm.
Like, you know when you can see that there's activity, but
It's
not warranted activity. I was like, this looks like a PR campaign for something. But I didn't know what it was. Now I've heard about the trainers and I've seen the video come out, it all makes sense now.
I just saw Satan, and then underneath Satan trading, it was Lil Nas X. Like, what's this? And then I just started seeing people chatting about, doesn't he fear God?
I saw this before that.
Why is he stripping on Satan? Why is he riding Satan? I was like, ugh.
I saw this before the video came out. So I saw trending. He was trending before that video came out, and they were talking about the song. They weren't talking about the video or any visuals. They were saying the song, and I was like, you know, you could just see the bot accounts and just like this.
I haven't got time. What's all this? Shout out Wavy and all that, but for this type of thing, I don't even acknowledge. It's like one of those things I just like even acknowledge. It's just another foolish thing.
To be honest, the one that I would actually be really interested in their views is the one that didn't even finish watching the video for whatever reason. You're the one that I actually want to know.
Well, you know it's you. It's more like a conspiracy against God.
It's more like to bother you than the three of us. It's in particular me and Wahala. Me and Wahala, I watched it and I felt nothing of it. Simple, I think, watched it and it's kind of like we shrug. It's like, I don't really care. I don't care enough about that kind of stuff. Whatever. Either which way, whether it's about the religious thing or the music itself or him or the social aspect of it. I don't care about any of them enough for it to rise me above giving just a very separated view of the video. And the video, for me, the thing is, I don't think the video is particularly well constructed in terms of, because you said it looked expensive. I think it looks tacky myself personally.
I didn't say that it did look tacky. I said it looked expensive.
So there's that. Outside of that, I have no issue with the twerking and the sliding down the pole and all that stuff. I didn't find it offensive. So in that regard, that bit wasn't a problem. The, you know, twerking on him, breaking his neck. I saw the symbology in the video. I understood it because, like you said, it's dealing with Genesis, but it's dealing with the devil. So that's that. So that's it. I look at it like that, but it's not the biggest deal in the world. But if you're somebody that you're a religious person, like some of those tweets have been going around, do you people not fear God anymore? Is this a joke? Like, you're looking at God and God is looking down at you. Am I a joke to you? Like, is this the type of thing that you put out on and you let children watch? Because that's something somebody else is saying. Is like, this is going to be shown, forget on MTV, like, this is on the internet. Kids is just there watching this thing now. It's like, is this what you want your kids growing up watching? Because what is the next generation gonna become if this is what's gonna get infused in them?
But let's be honest, as a counter argument to that, some of the stuff that our children have been exposed to already is just as bad. Like the themes of devils in music videos isn't new. I think there's been a season of existing artists that have all had videos or at least passages in their career where they went onto this very dark gothic and devilish theme. I think Rihanna had it at one point. She had devil symbolism in her stuff. Mm. I think Beyonce may have had it at one point as well. As far as rappers are concerned, you've had Hopsin that has done it. Who else is there?
Many rock and roll bands.
Many rock and roll bands. But I'm saying even in R&B and hip hop, there've been like people that have done themes around devil worship and all them kind of stuff. So it's not
usually men dressed in hot pants.
Yeah, but that's
leather,
why
leather hot pants twerking on the devil.
But yeah, so. But here's what I'm saying. So we only having an issue with it because it's coming in the format that is unconventional. Well, I'm saying the only reason why you're making mention of it is because it's coming in a format that's unconventional, in the sense that it's a guy doing it instead of traditionally where it would be a woman doing
and,
it.
And a guy kissing a guy in the video as well. That's a black guy kissing a snake that was...
Wasn't he kissing himself?
Yeah, but well, either way then, that's not something that you see every day on YouTube. And that's what some people might have more of an issue with that than the rest of it. It's like, I don't want my kids watching a man kissing a man. So forget the fact he's a snake. Let's just say a man kissing and forget the fact he's himself. I don't want them watching that. Not on the type. Not on. It's one thing if they're watching it on, I don't know, LA Law. Or you can see my age in it. I'm saying LA Law, you know, or whatever. How to Get Away with Murder or something like that. But my kids watch hip hop and that's what they follow. That's what they're into. I don't want them watching it and that because I'm happy. I'm happy for them to watch another gangland shooting and for some swearing. You know, I grew up on that. But I didn't grow up watching man kissing man.
I wonder how the filters work for YouTube and all this type of stuff. Because obviously the way that things are opening up now is a lot different from when we was.
There's no filters, man. There's kids YouTube and adult YouTube.
Only filter that works in YouTube is if you say something against Jewish people. That's the only filter that works.
No, the reason I'm saying that
everything else is allowed.
No, because you must be able to say you only want things that's over 18.
You can't say stuff about COVID.
If they're not ever 18 stuff there,
they lock you off. And
is there not something like they've got like 18 and up? No,
there's
kids YouTube.
There is a whole kids YouTube.
Yeah, but there's nothing like 18 and up or blah, blah,
no,
blah.
No, there's no rating system.
Yeah. So, because obviously, I'm saying the music videos, before, obviously, when you had MTV, if there was something that was, there would seem to be deemed as adult.
It
had to come on after a certain time, innit?
And that, so but it came on.
But it would come on after a certain time, which would indicate, obviously, this is something for an adult. Or sometimes there's some things come with warnings as well.
They come with warnings. There was edits as well. Sometimes there was MTV edits where you could
so
see
things like that. So yeah. If there's stuff that you really don't want your kids to watch no more, it's very hard to stop them.
Yeah, you can't.
It's mad. It's like, okay.
That's the point. Some people's like, I can't stop my children from being on the internet.
But they have same thing. They have this might have this problem with this. Same problem they had with WAP.
Well, there you go.
And they was complaining that this is the one I thought was the most fantastic thing. Cardi B was playing WAP.
And her daughter.
And her daughter walked in and she stopped it.
Yeah.
And people was upset with her, like, why are you stopping it for? And she's like, I didn't make this for my daughter. I don't know why you people keep playing this to your children. Like, I don't play this for my children. I remember there was one woman that had like a video and she had her daughter in the back and the daughter goes to her, Mom, what's wrong with that person's house? And she's like, what do you mean? She goes, why has he got so much holes in it? And she just looked at the screen. Because obviously she'd be playing WAP all day. And you know, there's some holes. People catch on, but Cardi B was, and they was ripping her to shreds. Like, why are you not allowing your daughter to hear it and our children should hear it? She's like, when did I ever tell any of you people to play this to your children?
What people don't realize is, I think who else does it? Some of these owners of like social media networks, they don't let their children go on the social media.
What's his name? Bill Gates. Was it Bill Gates that didn't allow his children to have
the Apple guy?
Oh, Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs, that didn't allow these children to go on social media or have a phone or something.
No, he didn't let them have an iPad.
Yeah. And someone else, one of these other execs from one of these other social medias, doesn't let their children
Most of them. It's well known. Loves being in tech.
Yeah. Listen.
It's well known that these guys do not let their children live off this stuff. Obviously, they give them devices and whatever, but they lock them down. Hard.
They don't let them have the crack.
Listen, Franklin Saint, whatever his name is, said you can sell it, but never smoke it.
Mm.
And that's what a lot of these people are saying with their products. You can sell it, but don't take it. Don't go on Twitter. It's not good for you. Mm. I'm selling this crack. I'm not asking you to smoke it.
Exactly.
I don't let my children smoke crack.
Exactly.
But I'm going to sell it.
Yeah.
If, you know what? Them mans were in front of the not Congress, the whatever. Okay. The American the heads of Twitter, Facebook, Google,
Fang
were sorry
Facebook,
Alphabet and Microsoft were in front of Senate. That's it. They were answering questions in Senate. They keep going up to Senate all the time because they're talking about
privacy and all that.
This thing. And this and blah blah blah. Like, did you have a role to play in this? Should you be looking down that? There's this big push and pull between government and social media right now. But whilst they were there, Jack is the head of Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
Man was tweeting whilst he was there. And one of the people caught him and she's like, oh, you're very good at multitasking, isn't it? And man started to basically smile because man was tweeting whilst he's there, like talking to these big people about what's going to happen with your business. And he was basically trolling them by tweeting whilst he was there. But that's
neither. But some people can only focus on two things at once. It's mad. It's mad. Some people can't focus on one thing and have to do something else to be able to focus on the other. It's mad.
I just pulled it up as an anecdote because it came up.
Mm-hmm. All right. So what are we getting into now?
There's the stuff that you brought up about Henri and the stuff that you brought up about being a deadbeat daddy. So those are the ones that I'll definitely want to include because those are the ones you brought up. And so I don't know how much time you have.
Well, my kind of links to what we were talking about before.
It does, exactly. But if he's got to go, and I'm sure he definitely wants to talk about the other thing, I think, you know, that would be important. So, depending on how much time you have.
I can't remember what it is.
Yeah, I've got about 20 minutes.
A gyming.
It's better we discuss your thing that you brought to the table first then.
We don't even need to talk about mine either.
Go on.
If you can't pay child maintenance, say bye to your passport. Is the headline on this?
You have to have one first.
On this tweet or social media post, and I didn't think that it had much weight. I just thought it was just one of those things. It says the UK will allow the DWP to cancel passports held by persons who have not paid child maintenance. By court order, the DWP can cancel a person's passport and prevent that person from getting a new passport if they fail to pay child maintenance.
Man or woman?
It doesn't say. I'm going to assume that that's what it is. And I sent it to somebody in particular who their sister was having some issues.
Receiving child support.
Yeah.
All right.
And
did they go giggity?
I wasn't sure if it was real, and they sent me some government documents, which made me think, wow, like this is actually for real. I just wanted to ask the man them what they thought about this. Do you know what I mean? Because, you know, there's one, you know, when you start to open these kind of cans, then other ones can open as well.
Pandora's box.
I think, get me,
Pandora's vagina.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not saying I'm not so much against this idea, because for me, any man that doesn't, who is given the opportunity, or who has the door wide open for you to be the father of the child that you created, and you decide
as
that
a
you
father,
are not, yeah, as a father, and you decide as a father that you're not going to, and you're going to manipulate a few things here and there to give the impression that you don't have finances, or to give the impression that, you know, that you ain't doing well enough. I know a few women that are going through some serious things, man. And if you are that kind of individual, that I'm not really backing you at all. I really think that is the ultimate waste for you to not be there, whether it is for time or financially for your child. I just think that that is a big, big problem, not just for your child and what that does to them mentally and emotionally, but just society in general. You get me? I think that it has a major impact on the upbringing of some kids. You know what I mean? So this is a big step, but I just wanted to know what the views were of everybody.
Can you pay child support if you are not allowed to see your child? I don't know this.
Levels? Yes. Yeah. Levels, I think there's some court orders
you
where...
You can't see your child, but you have to pay for the child.
Yeah.
My problem is this. I don't have a problem with people being punished for not paying child support. I have a problem with how they decide how much child support that person should pay.
Okay.
That's my issue.
But that's a completely different thing.
No, it isn't. Because if somebody tells you to pay something that is unreasonable, that you can't afford to actually pay it, and then they're going to remove your passport for something you can't actually do, then yeah, that's a problem.
I get the impression that whatever they ask for is usually peanuts.
No, it's not.
Are you sure?
I was not. It's not.
No, we're talking about in this country. From the very limited, because I don't know too many people in this situation, but the very limited ones I know, when I actually hear how much the man like has to pay, they might give more. But when I hear what they have to pay, it's nothing. It's like, is that it? It's like, yeah, that's what they said they have to do.
Yeah.
Like, peanuts.
There's many men that I know.
That wish they were for me.
Yeah.
That, bloody miles, dog, and I can't see.
That pay a certain amount that is more than what...
the government has asked them to.
CSA, Child Support Agency, would actually ask them to pay. I think they work it on a percentage of your earnings, and then a certain percentage of that if you have another child. You get me? From the same woman. But I'm not 100% sure as to how it all works out. I mean, I think everybody knows I've got two children. I'm not with the mother of my two children. We don't have that problem, because I'm not about that. You know what I mean? I just think the whole idea of it being a question to bring up, I just think is a madness. There are situations where men are put in a position where, you know, I've heard some real horror stories, bruv. Some real horror stories of some of the women that they've been with, that women have used the child as a pawn, they've used them as a weapon and what have you. But I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about women who have opened their door for the man to take care of their business, innit? And they just choose not to. Forget about it being, oh, you know, 60% of their earnings, or is it 20%, or is it 5%? They're just not doing anything. And sometimes they're doing such a minute and tiny amount that it is just embarrassing. You get me? So I get all of that, big wahala, but I'm just talking about the idea of taking this big step to punish men and women who decide that they are not going to pay what they should pay in.
I don't know how I feel about it. I do feel that you should pay support. I don't like the idea of just the courts getting involved full stop anyways.
Well, that's it.
That's for me, that's when it's like...
But that's what happens.
But if they have to get to that level...
A lot of the time. It happens all the time.
Because people refuse to pay. I know people that have said that they haven't seen their child's parent for months and months on end, and they have not given them anything.
Mm.
And then, so that's that one single parent now has to pay the brunt of that whole situation.
I understand why it happens. I'm just saying it hurts me, like, yeah, that it gets to that point.
So much. So, to be honest, if this is something that's going to really hurt them, then it'll be a good thing, because you might be seeing all these parents flying around the place. These parents might be spending all this money going
on. Yeah, look at it on the other side of the coin. You're there, you still follow your ex-partner on social media. They're not passing any money towards the upkeep of your child, and then you see them in Dubai. and you see them in Miami.
Exactly.
Yeah, that would burn. That would burn. And it's like, what? You can't give the minimum amount that the government is asking you to give, or whatever, the CSA or whatever it is. Like, it's a big slap in the face.
It is.
So fine. If you're going to party, you go party in Bournemouth, because you ain't going to Miami, because your passport gone.
Gone. If you want to pay your thing, you pay your thing. So I don't really mind a deterrent. I think it's a very strong deterrent, but I do agree with the fact that there should be some form of way of forcing you to pay your child support.
And end of the day, what it comes down to is, if you want your passport back, you pay the blood clot money, innit?
Yeah, and then you...
And that's it. It's not like, once it's gone for good. If you pay, then you get it back.
You know, the funny thing is that when, you know, people value certain possessions that they have, innit? Mm. You know, people value their homes. They value their cars. You get me? When someone has taken something like that of yours and they're saying that, listen, you're not getting this back until you pay, people find a way to pay.
Exactly.
You get me? So when you get someone who's had their car lifted, for it might be there's no tax on there, and it's been impounded, and it's going to cost, rather than costing you, I don't know, £150 to tax a car, you're going to have to pay £600 now. They're going to pay it, bruv. And they're going to find a way to pay.
And then still don't pay the tax.
Exactly.
That's a very good example.
Same thing with a bailiff or what have you. Some people will find a way.
I'm sorry to cut into you there.
Okay.
But here's my problem.
I knew you would have a problem.
With this.
You don't like Babylon getting involved.
It's not even that, yeah. It's really weird. So like you gave a very good example there with the car. That's a very good example. Yeah. What else was you going to say? There was the car and there was something else.
Bailiffs.
Very good example again. The problem I have is that those examples, there is a link between the two things. Yeah. So your car, you didn't pay road tax. They impound your car. You have to pay more to get your car back. Yeah. What the fuck does your passport have to do with your child?
I get you. There's no link, but it is something of value.
It's a punitive punishment.
Yeah, but it's not related to... There's
what do you want them to do?
There's no cohesion.
I was about to say...
I don't know what the solution is. I'm just saying that this is weird.
For me, it's like, I can't take your house because you need to live. I shouldn't take you away from your job because you need to make money to actually pay the child support. You know, I'm not going to slap you in jail because then I can't get any money from you there either. So what can I do to punish you? What can I do to make you give this money that you should be given? So what? I have to take something away from you.
Yeah, your citizenship.
What does that do for anything?
I don't think they're taking their citizenship.
No, but that's what you're basically doing by taking someone's passport.
I'm taking your right to move left, right, and centre. Your passport doesn't make you a citizen. They're freezing your passport so you can't use it to go elsewhere.
It's your right to travel. It's your right to free movement.
Yeah, that's what they're taking.
So they're removing your right to free movement because you didn't pay child support. That doesn't make any sense.
It's a punishment.
It makes sense.
It's a punishment. It may not be the type of punishment that is related to what you're doing. You understand this?
So what you're saying to me now is if this person makes their money by leaving the country, they're now going to... Can they still impose it? Based on what you just said, where they can't take your job because they need the money.
Well, give the money.
Pay your transport.
That's the point. No, you get it back if you pay the money.
No, but the point here is, I'm saying, they wouldn't take your job because they want the money for the child support.
Yes.
This is part of their job.
So if that is part of your job, and then you would have some money.
If I took your job, then you can't just walk back in and say, can I have your job? I can just give you a passport back. So that's what I'm saying. If somebody says you can't fly anymore because you don't pay your child support, then you pay your child support and say, okay, now you can fly.
No, but I'm saying...
Simple.
Yeah, go on.
The thing about this situation is...
Yeah.
They would have given you enough notice to tell you that they're going to do this thing. They're not just going to take it away tomorrow. They will say that you need to pay your child support. If you do not pay your child support within this period of time, we will remove your passport. So if you're working and you know that your whole reason of working is that you need your passport, if they've given you 6 months notice to tell you, or 6 weeks notice or whatever to tell you that we're going to remove your passport if you do not provide this amount of money, and you decide that you do not want to provide that amount of money, you have made a conscious decision that you are quite happy to lose your passport and lose your job potentially. They're not taking your job away from you. You are going out of your way to now decide that you're happy to lose that job.
Mm.
I think it's different.
That's a good point.
I mean, it's not me just saying, I'm taking your job tomorrow and blah, blah, blah. Even though it could be the same thing, I could say I'll take your job. And if you don't pay your 6 weeks job time, I can take your job. Although I don't think the government can actually take someone's job away, which is why I think it's different. I think this is something they can actually control.
But what I'm saying to you is if your job is directly linked to your ability to travel, then they are taking your job.
So do something about it.
No, they're not.
They are.
No, they're
imagine
not.
If you're...
Your employer could say to them, oh, well, we can do you something else. You can stay in the office.
So, no, let's say you're a flight attendant, for example.
Yes.
Or a pilot.
Then you can work in other areas in the airport.
Let's just say that, for argument's sake, let's say that it is now. You will lose your job. It still doesn't negate what Wahala said. You have the chance to pay it. And if you choose not to pay it, then you've chosen to lose your job. To lose your job. What's wrong with me? You've chosen to lose your job. That's your choice.
The
only option or the only thing there, the only out that I give you is that you cannot actually afford to do it. You're in some mad debt somewhere else. You owe some drug dealers X amount of money or whatever it is. And you cannot, literally you cannot afford to give the money that you get into your account from your job to the parent.
I think that they only get to that point when they've done the assessment, innit? So they'll do their financial assessment and say that you can pay, but you are not paying.
But I'm not going to tell you about Sharky that I buy my blow from that I owe 10 grand to, and he's going to chop off my legs and kill my kid if I don't give him the money.
I'm saying Sharky, yeah, but you know. I'm saying so in
I'm not saying that it is the right move.
Yeah,
but I'm just putting it out.
But I understand.
Yeah, my position. I do. My position isn't that child support shouldn't be paid. By the way, because I didn't say that in the beginning.
Have you been paying for your other children?
Yes.
he may have Lux, but he's not one of them.
So yeah, I'm not saying that child support shouldn't be paid. 100% definitely should. But this implementation, I think, is a bit. I'm side.
So what should be the punishment? Then?
I don't know what the punishment should be. I just think that this one's a bit weird.
I think this country is weird.
Now, I think anything that ethnic minorities have with regard to passport is we're already on edge.
I know. Why is it that it seems to be like
we're on edge, blah? Because our passport is the most important thing apart from the fact it might even just be the most important thing
because it's the only way to get back to Africa. But I'm saying,
yeah, if they have multiple passports, then it's not a big deal, innit?
I got my Nigerian one, fam.
I'm saying,
can bounce here.
Echo us, man.
Yeah, so I'm saying for this, even with this child support thing, I don't understand, how or why, because you're saying to me, how else could the government possibly do it? Let's do it this way then. Why don't they just do it the same way they do tax? You've never seen your money before tax. They tell you what your money looked like before tax, but
some people do it. That's how they do it, I think. Some people, I think you can opt to do it where they just take it out.
I'm saying not opt, because you don't opt to pay tax. You pay tax. The government takes the tax from you.
Yeah.
Then they got the fucking cheek to come back to you whenever they were and send you letters that, oh, you didn't pay enough or you overpaid or what have you. Now you need to talk to
them. So it's a madness.
It's not a matter of not being able to do it. If they can prove that you're the parent of the child and they can prove that you have reasonable enough income to be able to pay what they're asking for the child, why don't they just take it the same way they do tax?
I think you have to opt in for that one under current rules. Because your employer has to do all of that stuff as well. So it has to be a whole thing where your employer, you and the government, all three of you say, yes, this is what we're willing to do. Because you're now your employer's paying that money to the government.
But
I do get, I'm sure that there is something out there where they leverage
my point is,
I think it must be an opt-in thing. It must be, do you want us to take it out of your
I don't
pay,
opt in to pay
or
tax.
Or do you want to pay it your own?
I don't opt in to pay tax. No one asked me if I wanted to pay tax or not. And I've had to accept that tax needs to be paid. So if we're in this situation now, because like you said, it's not straight away. It's a road. There's a road to you get to that point. If we're in that situation, I don't understand why the road isn't the same as with tax, where you don't really have a choice. As long as we can prove that the child is your child biologically or what have you, then you got to pay the money.
It makes sense, but the way how they put tax in the hierarchy of crimes is not going to be... child support is never going to be anywhere near it. You can get
they don't
more
give a shit
for tax evasion than you... can for murder.
I know, which means that they don't really give a shit then, isn't it? So what do you call it?
Your spidey sense?
Yeah. Now it's making my
shout out
DJ Webs.
Yeah. Now it's making my conspiracy theorist side come out now. Like, why are you fucking passport of all things? In the most sensitive time that we're in now,
requisite.
Where passport is a big thing. We've had people who are saying that they're British when Brexit happened, now all of a sudden they're drawing for their French, they're drawing for their Spanish, they're drawing for all of their, you know what I mean? Like, the number of applications for Irish passports went up incredibly because they were like, well, boy, I can still, you know, my mum's half. So we've got those passport things going on. And then we're now just being told that we're not going to be able to fly until after August now. So it's for me, it's just weird. Why the passport? Why now? Why this timing? It just doesn't make no sense.
Mm. So you're weary of a few things happening within the last 12 months around people leaving this country.
Yeah. And it's again, this passport thing is, I would link it to a civil liberty of some description. And I'm always suspicious when there is a bid to push things through, because what they will do on the legislation is they will push to the surface for the PR, something that's really relatable to people. But when you actually check the logic of what's going on in the legislation, it actually affects something else.
It's always terrorism or child abuse. Those are the two things. And then they push something with the header of that.
Exactly.
And then when you delve into it, it's like, yeah, but now we can check into your social media or your internet.
Precisely.
Or go through your house or go through your ISP.
Precisely.
Because, yeah, you might be associated with somebody who used to be dead and is alive, was back then, and used to know somebody that was did this.
Precisely.
And that.
It's always, so I get mighty suspicious when it comes to the surface like this. I'm just like,
And there's this thing going on now, actually. We've run out of time, really, so we can't talk about it now, but this thing with the government is pushing this agenda about stopping people protesting, basically. How they're trying to lock that.
I think it was a few years ago.
You can't protest it in the group of one.
Yeah.
You can't make noise.
Yeah, it's illegal.
I think it started
actually implemented yet, but they're voting it through. And I think there's X amount of different votes they've done. I think they've gone through two.
First motion started with, students when they started protesting about 4 years ago. And that's when they started to put this in motion.
If you can't protest, is that a democratic society?
Well,
your protest is dictated, is that a democratic society?
I've always said that, and this is just me, that democracy is just a farce, bruv.
It's a story that they tell themselves, isn't it?
Yeah, and
I've lived in this country all my life. I've never lived in a democracy, never.
And many people believe it, and you know, so far as the masses believe that they really have a voice, then that's it. I always said, I think that a vote really does count for your local MP. If you can get in touch with your local MP and have an influence on your local MP, then I think you can. And I've seen people influence their local council. But on a mass scale, they're going to do what they want to do. You know what I mean? Whether you want them in power or not. You know, this whole COVID thing would have happened. A lot of things would have happened. Tax would have gone up, whether it was Labour or Conservatives. A lot of things would have happened regardless of who's in power. That's just my opinion.
Speaking of who's in power, Stav, I know you're into politics. Is Keir Starmer a Tory in disguise?
I don't know.
He's just useless. That's the
yeah.
They all are.
Nah, he has to be anti-Corbyn, innit? He has to be the other side of the coin from Corbyn. Yeah, so I don't think Corbyn was super effective, as much as I liked what he said. I truly believe that if he came into power, he wouldn't have been as effective as many people that backed him for. And I just think that Keir is just literally the other side of that coin. Like, I have to be the other side of the coin. So I do the kneel for Black Lives Matter, and then I say my nonsense afterwards, instead of attacking conservatives. That, because I'm not always one for these people that you should quit, because that's a politician's thing. You make a mistake, quit. You should quit. I don't believe that's life. Same way I don't believe in cancel culture. I don't actually believe it should be applicable in politics either. But
how about for Derrick?
But he can do what he wants to do. I just enjoy the fact that he's getting trolled, because he did something. I like those four boys. So with him, there's people that have outright done a nonsense with this Brexit stuff, and they've made so many mistakes. And what he keeps saying is, no, I don't think they should lose their job, but they
because he knows that he should lose his job. So what for? That. Why rubbish?
I actually don't. I just see him as he's a weak figure. Unfortunately, he came in.
You are the weakest link. Goodbye.
He came in decent, because he came off the back of Corbyn and the Conservatives. Then Brexit happened. I mean, sorry, not Brexit.
Corona.
Corona happened, and Conservatives messed up left, right, and centre. And he seemed like a sensible person on the other side, a level-headed person.
I said,
this ex-lawyer, this person that used to fight for human rights and all that stuff. And then he was talking sense, and Labour's what's it called? Their polls were rising and rising up to the point because they were so far behind Conservatives, and then they were level. You know, they've fallen behind Conservatives now. Boris is now, since the vaccine has gone through and everybody seems like we're going over the hurdle of COVID, his status is now rising again. Shout him out for banging his thingy whilst he was married again with his ex, you know, whatever.
Who's that, Boris?
Boris is banging, man. One of his old pieces has come out saying, "Yeah, we were banging for 4 years during his ex. He was pregnant and he was banging."
Is that the stripper one?
No, no. She worked.
I think secretary, isn't
it? Yeah, I don't know, but she worked
within the thing.
Around.
They're all a bunch of jokes. Listen, you know, the whole Labour Party is funny, and they're
too
gonna,
much infighting,
and,
man.
And they're gonna, sorry,
too much infighting.
Yeah, I mean, all of that. But when you haven't got a sufficient leader who can lead and who can show leadership, then this is what the face of the Labour Party is going to be like. And it all started when a brother backstabbed another brother.
Yep. Because if David came back,
you want to go back all the way.
No, yeah, but no. If David, if David
was talking about their brother,
no, if David was David,
sorry. If David Miliband came back today, he would become the leader and they would win.
I think is he the one that's dealing with stuff in Africa?
He went to America for some time.
Oh, yeah, he's in a think tank or something like that.
Yeah. He would have won, man. The stupid brother because of you people that like unions. Let's go, man.
The one thing I will say about Keir Starmer is that the only thing he seems to come hard on is anti-Semitism. Because of what happened again, because he has to be the other side of that coin.
Yeah,
the thing that annoyed me the most about him is when he was Xing people out for having statements about this anti-Semitism stuff. One person just liked a tweet, and then he took away the whip from her. And that's like, nah, bruv. Like, have some decorum and some common sense. It's like he wanted to come to the other side so hard that he just started doing a bit of a nonsense. And then that really came down to pandering. Taking into account his missus is Jewish, so maybe that's got, maybe he's getting it at home. I don't know. If his missus,
make sure you do the right thing.
Exactly, because if your guy, whatever the person is, and they're getting rinsed somewhere, and you have some sort of power, your partner at home always, hey,
I'll tell my daddy about you.
You better look after yourself. But anyways, before we go, actually, what do you think? Do you think he's a Tory in disguise?
I don't know, man. He seems to be amply placed to be causing enough confusion. And like you said, the polls have now gone back in Tory favor. I don't know, man. I feel like you can put, what'd you call them?
Plants.
A plant in the right place.
Labour ain't getting in power for a long time.
Long time.
Yeah.
Very long time.
And that would make him a plant.
Right. On that note, we will say our church notes. And our goodbyes, and we'll start off with Mr. Wolf.
What's going on? You can catch me on Instagram on aka Mr. Wolf, on Twitter on aka _ Mr. Wolf. God bless you all. I love you all. Be nice to everybody. Peace.
Simple Simon.
At Simple Simon FB on Twitter. I don't have Instagrams. Nah, plug, not nah, bumbugla this week. At least. Oh, no, something came up. Ghana is doing mad things with drill right now. I'm feeling Ghanaian drill. If you get a chance, look up a guy named Medical. He's sick. That's about it. My gun, and my gun again. See it there? Boom.
Big Wala.
At Big Wild Lines, at Big Wild on Twitter. At One Stop Dreadlock for your do-rags and swimming caps, as I said at the beginning of the show.
Plug.
Check out Invincible on Amazon. That's decent. First 3 episodes out already. My nephew put me on that one, boy.
Very violent, but yes, I was as well.
Plug.
My nephew put me on, and when I saw my brother-in-law, he's the first week, have you started watching Invincible? So I was like, yeah, I started watching. So yeah,
you could check all of you are there talking about your anime.
Yeah. Also check out Tina Turner documentary as well. That just came out on Sky recently. That's quite good.
Tina Turner. But I've seen 2 plays about her, documentary, a film.
Yeah, apparently she's wrapping up. The way she's saying it, making it sound is a bit weird. She's like, she's wrapping up her career, she's saying.
Why does that sound strange? She's in her 80s or something?
When you wrap up your career, it's almost sound like you're dying.
She's old. She doesn't need to keep performing and stuff anymore.
Retiring.
Yeah, she's retiring, but she's saying a rap. She's saying wrapping it up. Like, I just don't. It don't sound right. No one.
I hear what you're saying.
But anyway, it's fine. But anyways,
Yeah, I just didn't see it as that. But anyway, that's it.
So 81.
Yeah, she's 81.
Let the woman rest. All right. Without putting cancer on her, man. Don't curse her. You're done.
Yeah.
All right. I am Stavros Bus. You can catch me at Stavros Bus everywhere on all the social medias. My Stavros Says this week is a podcast, a fellow podcaster. It's a half-cast podcast. On YouTube, it's called Losing My Bonus Parents. But on the actual podcast, on the audio one, is like Bonus Dad or whatever. So it will be like the second to last one maybe that's come out as this is being released. And it's Chucky talking about losing his stepdad. And remember last week or the week before, I was saying that I wanted to reach out to somebody a while back, but I don't know him. I didn't get any. I don't have any links to him.
Mm-hmm.
And their social media, for me anyways, to access them is closed. I couldn't send an inbox. It was him. I've heard him talk about his stepdad for the past 6 months or so. He only drops in the odd thing. He doesn't like delve too deep into his private business. But he said something was wrong with his dad. He had a long term illness, and he's discussing it now. He's passed on. Rest in peace to his stepdad. And he's talking about how much he rates his stepdad. His dad is still very, very much in his life, and he's like the both of them were there. And he's like, his dad respects his stepdad. His stepdad he's talking about that synergy he has and all of that stuff. For me, it was a very powerful. Episode, and there's a bit where he's talking about, he didn't go into it, but I think he was assisting his dad with type of things that you might not have to usually want to assist your an elder person for. And something that actually brought tears to my eyes is when he said it was an honor to do it, and I thought that was so powerful. He's like, it was an honor for me to do that for him, for all the things that he's done for me. I think that's a really powerful episode, so everyone should go back and listen to that. You can catch us collectively at ESN Podcast on all the social medias. Here's the thing, if you need to go, hashtag ESN Pod to start or join in the conversation. This is my old school to new school. I'm going to switch off to these mics so that this one can leave. Listen to this song. Shuffle.
I went to a theater and I saw the Cool and the Gang show.
By Cool and the Gang.
I always wanted to get into a band to sing my songs and then become a bad piano player.
Party people in the place to be. It's about that time.
Yeah. What you know about going out?
Head West, Red Legs, TVs, call up in the head. I think that's one of the best starting lyrics for a song ever. What you know about going out? Head West, Red Legs, TVs, call up in the flow on that.
Get your nut till I can't get it up. I'm a big man, get this man room. I done hit everything from Cancun to Grand Tune. Why you standing on the wall, hand on your balls, lighting up drugs.
And this is Feel So Good by Mace.
I'm the reason they made the dress code. To figure out what and why when I'm in my fresh clothes. Dresses, I suppose, from my neck to my toes.
Alright, thank you very much for tuning in. Peace, blessings, love, and all the above. Stay safe.
And remember, if you ain't saying nothing, say it well.
Slag for life.
Let's begin. Bring this BS to an end.
Come on.
ESN Podcast. Welcome to ESN Podcast.
That's what we do.
Come on, I wouldn't change it. I wouldn't change it. Welcome to the ESN Podcast.